tape of the other night. Gary Garver went out.
That should be right in front of Howard.
I hate to tell you, but...
It isn't right in front of you?
It is not there.
I think it's right in front of you. You see him? Was it right in front of me? No. I bet they're right in front of you. I have a feeling they are. All right, then forget it. I don't care. Not that. Not that important. I just want to get some of the tape out of the way. All right, it's not here. Forget it. What's that? Here, Gary Garver. They're over here.
I didn't put them there.
You didn't put them there? No. Right. Wonder who put them there. You put them there? Okay. All right. His breath is a little bit bad.
Oh, dear.
He just caught a whiff.
But he's been working on it.
He's working on it. All right, Gary Garver with Mike Farrell is the funniest one.
Oh, yeah.
This is really good. Mike Farrell is the guy who was on MASH. Remember?
Ruined MASH.
The guy who ruined MASH, essentially. Yeah. Remember the guy, remember when MASH started out, it was really good because they had that guy, Wayne
Rogers,
and then he split for some unknown reason.
Mike Farrell is to MASH fans what that kid in the stands is to Cub fans.
So Mike Farrell was hired as BJ Honeycutt, and he kind of sucked.
Yeah, he was all good and nice.
Yeah, just ruined it.
And he's humorless. Listen to him with Gary Garver. I mean, the guy has no fun.
How you doing?
Good. Who are you?
I'm with Infinity Broadcasting.
With who?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Oh, I know where's Infinity Broadcasting.
We're like Viacom, you know, we own all these, you know, Paramount.
Okay.
I'm just part of the small fray there.
Hey, what do you think of, I know you're a big Democrat, what do you think of Arnold Schwarzenegger being governor?
I think it's too bad. I think it's a triumph of celebrity over sense, and I think that it's a... You know, it remains to be seen. He may be a good governor. I hope so. But I think that this is, I think the recall was inappropriate, and I think it's actually a defeat for democracy.
Do you think that the quality of shows suck on television now because all the money goes to the actor and less money goes to production values?
I don't think all the money goes to the actors. I think a lot of shows aren't very good on television today, but I think it has more to do with the fact that it's a ratings chase than it has to do with where the money goes.
What was your initial reaction to the Kobe Bryant arrest?
Sadness.
Have you ever done a black chick?
Are you from this that asshole show?
Howard Stern?
Yeah.
Couldn't he let him think up the name himself?
No, not Howard Stern.
He knew exactly who he was talking about. Oh, you mean Howard?
Yeah, I work with him.
Yeah.
What, you don't like Howard?
I don't like being ambushed and being asked stupid questions and being put in a position where I'm going to be asked to say things that might be turned into a way to make me look foolish on the radio or on television. I think that's really horseshit.
You think I try to make you look foolish?
I think that's what you're trying to do, yeah.
I'm not trying to. I'm just asking stupid questions.
Well, asking stupid questions is a way to try to make somebody look foolish.
But, I mean, you played in MASH. I mean, you guys were funny then. I mean, it was my favorite show. Why you get pissed off? I mean, it's just a joke. Don't you think it's just a joke? It's just media.
If you were to come up to me and say, look, I'd like to do a joke interview with you and say and ask you a bunch of dumb questions and see what you want to say to them, then I'd be doing it straight up. This is not doing it straight up.
But if I said I was with the Howard Stern Show, would you do the interview with me?
No, I wouldn't.
Probably wouldn't. So how could I do that? Do the interview?
Can't. Doing the Howard Stern Show is not a way to get an interview with me.
All right. Thanks a lot, Mr. Farrell.
I seem to recall him coming on our show once at NBC. Am I crazy?
No, he did.
He did, right?
Yeah, he did.
I guess I didn't impress him.
Gary reminded me the comment that actually made him laugh was you said to him, I'll bet the person who booked you on here will probably be fired. And he actually laughed with you at that point. That's the only time he laughed.
I see. Well, he's, you know, listen, I mean, he's got to be a bitter guy. He ruined MASH. You know. Here's Gary Garver with Rob Reiner, who played Meathead on All in the Family.
Do you have a sense of humor?
Does he have a sense of humor? I don't remember.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Big fan of yours from All in the Family and all those things.
Thank you, man.
If you weren't in show business, do you think that you could make a living at doing anything else?
No.
I don't know. What is this? Who am I talking to? Who are you talking to?
Infinity Broadcast.
Who are you? Huh?
Infinity Broadcast.
Oh, Infinity Broadcasting. What is Infinity Broadcasting?
We're, you know, Viacom, Infinity.
Oh, okay.
All those radios.
All right, okay. Yeah.
Do you think the charges against Kobe Bryant are racially motivated at all?
No, I'm not really qualified to talk about this stuff.
Hey, how do you feel about Arnold Schwarzenegger being governor of California?
Well, he's he was duly elected, and he certainly got the support of everybody. I'm going to try to give him as much support as I can. I'm a good friend of Arnold's, and I think he'll hopefully do a great job.
Ever paid for sex?
No.
What do you think of Howard Stern?
I'm not doing this conversation. I don't want to have a conversation with you. You don't sound like a person who's in a real media to me.
Thanks.
That did not go well. Yeah. Well, it is the real media.
It doesn't sound like a person who's in the real media. No.
I love how Mike Farrell goes, if you tell me it's a joke interview, then it'll be funny.
No, it won't.
Yeah.
He doesn't know.
Yeah. Mr. Sense of Humor.
Here's Gary Garver with the Reverend Jesse Jackson.
Mm.
All right, that's a big score, a big coup for him.
Reverend Jackson, how you doing?
How are you?
Happy birthday.
Thank you, sir.
How old are you?
62.
You look great.
Nah, I feel great, too.
Do you think...
Thank you, buddy. I know your roast game has been crazy.
Yeah, a little crazy.
But thanks for being here. Well, let's talk soon, if we can. I'd like to share...
Pompous ass is blowing him off right during the interview.
kind of where we are. All right? Don't miss my step. Yes, sir.
Do you think Arnold Schwarzenegger will make a good governor of California?
Well, I hope he will. The people of the state deserve stability. This recall was really a destabilizing act, and I hope that the threshold will be raised for us to discourage this kind of activity in the future. In many ways, the recall was a retaliation by the losers of the election of a year ago. And there's nothing to stop another retaliation, but it should not happen. We should raise the threshold so that we can have an orderly 2-year, 4-year, 6-year election cycle.
He's got verbal diarrhea.
That has served us well.
Does the public know the real Jesse Jackson?
They know what they see, what they don't see. What they know is that for 40 years I've really worked very much in the public eye, fighting for social justice, whether working with Dr. King or Whitney Young or Earl Wilkins, Nelson Mandela or Cesar Chavez or Nelson Mandela. Across these years, I've simply did my best to make America better and the world more secure.
When you die, will Christ be in your thoughts?
Christ is in my DNA.
Have you ever sneezed and farted at the same time?
That sounds silly to me.
Thanks a lot, Reverend.
Sounds silly to me.
Christ is in his DNA.
Man. I never know what he's talking about.
Nelson Mandela, Cesar Chavez, or Nelson Mandela?
He likes Nelson Mandela. Man.
He said Nelson Mandela twice.
Yeah, Nelson Mandela, or Cesar Chavez, or Nelson Mandela.
Dr. King.
Dr. King.
Crosses in my sneezes and faults.
Crosses in my DNA.
Hey, I just want to compliment Stuff Magazine. Their cover of Carmen Electra is very, very beautiful. It looks like to me, Carmen Rumberry died yesterday. If you remember him from the 70s.
What's happening?
What's happening? So we dug this out. I don't think we ever played this on the air. Gary Garver saw him at some, charity event or something. He interviewed Fred Rerumberry. It's always good to hear a guy right after he died. So here it is. Fred Rerumberry.
How you doing, Fred? I'm with CBS Radio.
Great. I'm doing real good.
What brings you here today?
I'm just hanging out at the Retro Fest, having a good time.
Retro Fest. That's a drag, huh?
They might not have even invited him. He might have just shown up.
He might have just paid for a ticket.
Yeah.
Retro Fest.
Yep.
Which is another nice thing for those conventions where...
It's where TV show actors...
Go
once they don't get TV work anymore.
Believe it or not, I've been to Retro Fest.
Hey, it's Retro Fest actually is wonderful.
Signing autographs, and they have a booth outside. So just hanging out, having a good time.
What's the bravest thing you ever did?
The bravest thing I ever did? I flunked 10th grade. On purpose.
Do you think there will ever be a black president in the United States?
Yeah, but he had to run pretty damn fast. Dodging the bullets.
Do you think the media portrays blacks in a negative way?
Only on television and in the movies.
Who's your favorite white person?
My favorite white, oh, Hillary Clinton.
Really?
Oh, yeah, by far. Sexy, too.
Do you think the black children adopted by Steven Spielberg will grow up with a warped sense of identity?
No, but they'll be hell of a filmmakers.
Do you ever frighten white people just for the hell of it?
Hell yeah!
Wow.
How
good. That's some gay character, huh?
Do you consider yourself average or above average in penis length?
Average or above in penis length? That's a hard one, man. You want to check?
Oh, really?
He must have been a lot of fun on the set.
Is he trying to attract attention to himself?
Maybe.
You know, to get the people who are in line to get their autographs to realize he's there?
I hadn't thought of that.
Wow.
Oh, would you commit a homosexual act for $1 million?
Hell no. I'd commit a heterosexual act for $1 million.
Do you enjoy the benefits of Viagra?
I've actually tried Viagra, man. It didn't work on me. Huh? No. No, I have to masturbate anyway.
What the hell?
It seems like Henry Hill.
How does Viagra not work on you? I don't know.
How often do you masturbate?
Let me see. 1,000 times a year, maybe.
Who do you love more, your mother or your father?
Black guy always says my mother. A lot of times the father's not around.
I love my father. I hate my mother.
Wow. Interesting.
Look at you.
That guy breaks all stereotypes. How many black guys laugh like that?
None.
No, I'm just joking. Okay.
How many dates do you have with a woman before you introduce anal sex?
Anal sex? Man, I don't let her perform anal sex on me until the second day.
Have you ever smoked marijuana?
Tons.
Sounds it.
Thanks a lot, Fred. What do you think of Howard Stern?
I love Howard. Howard is my God.
Really?
Matter of fact, you know, a lot of people say, well, Howard's really mean and nasty and he'll get your goat, but he is one of the sweetest people I've ever met. My first interview was in the studio with him. And this last one, he was trying to get me a new TV series. He's calling up all of the networks and saying, get rerun back on television. Just a really sweetheart, man.
Oh, grab him. He's going to hear these words.
All right, thanks.
Thanks a lot, Fred. Take care, man.
Thank you, man.
God bless you.
Now I feel bad. He's gone.
Yeah.
Hope he remembered me in that will of his. I didn't realize he should have played the Joker with that laugh.
Somebody ripped him off.
Meg's on the phone. Let's just hear her.
Let's make you feel at home. Kids, follow me. Say, ba-ba-booey!
Yes, ba-ba-booey. My ba-ba-booey. 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 Fire!
Baba Booey.
All right.
Baba Booey.
You want to let Gary Garver plug? They gave him a radio show out in Los Angeles.
How did they?
I think on Sunday nights at like 3 in the morning. There's a vote of confidence.
Oh.
Hey, Gary. Gary Garver.
Hey, Howard.
Hey.
How you doing?
When's your radio show?
It's Saturday night at 9 p.m.
Oh, that's not 3 in the morning.
It's better than what I said. What's the show about?
It's going to be about being single in L.A.
Well, you certainly know about that. Your wife dumped your ass.
Yeah, and so did my lesbian lover.
You didn't have a... I heard about that.
What was that all about?
I feel bad for Gary. I mean, he's like real lonely and...
Gary's a good guy, man.
But what happened? A lesbian lover?
Well, he met this chick who was gay.
I didn't know she was gay when we first went out.
Yeah, well, he starts going out with her, and, like, he started to put the moves on her, and then she goes, well, I'm gay. And then they became, like, best friends and did everything together, except one thing.
Yeah.
They didn't have sex.
Yeah.
And, like, he was, like, all hung up on a chick who wouldn't give him any sex. And,
oh, that's awful.
And then,
that's called chasing Amy.
Yeah, and then it became worse because she dumped him.
No, she didn't dump me. I just realized that it was going nowhere, and I just
forget. He realized it was going nowhere.
Well, what was your hint?
And he was taking her on ski trips.
Oh, you mean took her to Mexico. Major money?
He took her to Mexico.
Oh.
Yeah, I went to Cabo with her.
You're crazy.
Went to Cabo with a gay chick who probably was really hot.
She was.
Yeah.
So did you go out and pick up chicks together or something? What was going on?
No, he was into her.
Yeah, I was into her, but we like the same kind of chicks.
And he's a disaster with women anyway, because...
Yes.
No, I'm not.
His wife broke up with him because he cheated.
You have to bring that up again.
And then, like, then he started...
Where's the girl you cheated with? She didn't even want you.
I don't want to see her.
Because she's a bummer.
Yeah.
Just reminds you of bad times.
You know what your problem is, if you don't mind me saying?
Go ahead.
His problem.
Aren't you, like, a big pothead?
Yeah, I like smoking weed.
Yeah.
But I'm not a big pothead, Howard. I mean, I like smoking, but that doesn't mean anything, man.
I'm just saying, maybe it's too much weed.
I don't smoke that much, man. I drink a lot, though.
Oh, maybe it's the combination of the two.
Maybe you have to drop one.
Yeah.
I can't.
It's impossible. I don't know. But he's been chasing this lesbian for a while, and she's hot. I get it. Like, you think you're going to convert her, but...
Yeah.
Gary's going to convert her?
I know.
What's the chance of
that? And it's real sad because he's lonely.
Yeah, I am. I have to admit I am.
Are you coming to Vegas again this year?
I sure am.
Yeah, we'll see you there.
Are you bringing your brother?
Why don't you set me up with somebody out there?
What?
Why don't you set me up with somebody out there?
Yeah, don't bring your brother again.
I'm not.
His brother and him got into a fist fight.
Yeah, his brother just gets everybody crazy.
But not like brothers just like clowning around. Gary punched them out.
But it was like Doug Goodstein almost got into a fight with his brother.
Yeah, it started with Doug.
And so don't bring him.
The brother was like being a real ass.
Yeah.
From what I heard.
He was drunk and he didn't know what he was saying.
What did he say to Doug?
He said that I was like the producer of the show or something, the TV show or something like that.
Hmm.
Pissed everybody off and then...
Yeah, I think it was Doug overheard him telling somebody that... He was Doug, you know, it was like basically he was describing what Doug does, and Doug's standing right there.
Well, I think he kicked Doug out of a chair, right? He said, get out of this chair, because it's from my brother who's producer.
It was a whole big fight. It was a big fist fight, right, Brian?
Yeah, we had a party, and he was kicking Doug out of the party. And Doug was the one who arranged the party. And he's going, I'm Howard Stern's producer's brother. He was saying something crazy.
Right.
Yeah.
And then,
don't bring that brother of yours.
I'm not. Don't worry.
Yeah, we were planning Vegas yesterday. We came up with some good stuff. We're gonna.
What?
Well, my room has a bowling alley.
Yeah.
Because the Hard Rock wants to, to give me a good treatment and stuff, and they do it. A great place.
But like bowling alley.
A full bowling alley. So we're gonna get some homeless guys up there and have homeless bowling. Yeah.
That's cool.
I assume that'll be after you check out.
Oh, my goodness. Where are we going? Who's got that job? Who's got to go round up the homeless?
Gary and John.
Oh, my goodness.
As long as my room can be sectioned off.
And fumigated.
Right. How funny is that going to be? Homeless bowling.
That's great.
And then we bet on them and stuff?
Oh, it's the best.
Who are you taking?
I got to size them up.
I'm taking the smelly one.
Which one would that be?
All of them.
Howard, the day after that fight.
You're stupid.
I got this guy.
The morning after that fight, Gary had me and Fred. So, Fred, do you remember this? We saw Garver at the Starbucks in the Hard Rock the next morning.
Yeah.
I've never seen a more hungover human being.
We smelled him before we saw
him. I mean, it was as bad as I've been. I actually said, Gary, do you need some help?
What was it, too? Your wife broke up with you, and then didn't she become born again or something?
Nah, she was always born again. That's one of the reasons we didn't see eye to eye.
So did she run off with a religious dude?
Yeah, she did. She ran off with, I think he was a Jehovah's Witness or something.
Oh, God. The guy who knocks on the door?
Yeah, I don't think he knocked on doors, but I think she told me he went to church on Saturday.
Well, Gary Garver was going around all depressed and trying to get his wife back. And quoting and then he started quoting the Bible, trying to get her back.
There ain't nothing wrong with that.
What was it you started chanting to her from the Bible?
We
started to read Bible scripture.
Right. Leviticus 3:18 states it's an abomination to do that.
I think it was Ezekiel or something.
Ezekiel.
All right, so who gave you the show?
It's actually being sponsored by Troubadour's Gourmet in Woodland Hills. It's a bar in the Valley. And what we're going to do is we're going to have the show from 9 to 10, and then afterwards we're going to throw the party, you know, the radio show to the restaurant and put singles together out there.
Now, let me ask you, you're doing it from the restaurant?
No, we're going to do it from the studio in L.A., and then after the show, I'm going to go down there and make an appearance, and then I'm going to have people who called in.
Wait a second. You're going to put singles together?
He can't get himself together.
I can't even get laid.
Well, I think with the radio show, maybe you'll get laid.
Possibly.
Yeah.
Possibly.
All right, Gary Garver, everybody. Listen to him Saturday nights on KLSX in Los Angeles at 9 o'clock.
Hey, thanks a lot, Howard. I'll see you guys out in Vegas. Let's party.
All right, Gary.
Yeah, keep your brother home.
I promise I will. Let's roll some craps, baby.
Man, every time we go to Vegas, I don't even see Gary Garver.
I know. I sometimes notice him in the audience, but I've never seen him anywhere where we go. Yeah.
Well, you guys never let me go anywhere where you're near.
Well, apparently, Robin, you're not at the bar at 4 a.m. Because I see him every year.
All right, Gary, later.
All right, take care. Thanks.
Gary Garver, or the guy who does all those interviews.
Yeah.
He's a good guy.
Chases OJ down. He's a good dude.
He's great with OJ. But it was a riot. How is she going to see Liza?
Come all right. So Gary Garver ran into Gary Busey.
Oh.
Who's always funny. And this time we told Gary Garver, our reporter, we said, when you see celebrities, ask them if they know what's going on in Haiti.
Ah.
And we made Gary Garver read everything about Haiti so that he would be, like, so that he could follow up and go, no, you're not right. This is what's going on in Haiti.
So he had to study Haiti in order to do this interview.
Yeah, so the Haiti thing, you'll see why Gary Garver tries to get into it.
All right.
Because he knows everything about Haiti now. We made him read everything. All right, here we go. CD one.
Gary.
Yeah.
Hey. What do you need?
And do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews? Do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews?
No. Making movies everywhere, that's the idea. Get out of the greed pocket, the money game, and the game of exploitation and the game of betrayal. Give the money to the people making the story to put it on the screen to give messages of hope and love and spirituality. And wherever that country we do that in, they do that in, all of us do that in, is the right place to be.
Are you for or against stem cell research and why?
I'm for it.
You're for it? How about you, Gary?
I'm for it, too.
Do you support the president's plan to ban a homosexual marriage?
I have nothing to say about that. That has to do with the Bible, and I'm very much a strong, full-blooded Christian. So I know how I feel about that, but I'm not going to get in a political arena with this question.
Do you think Martha Stewart is being made a government scapegoat?
No. She deserves what she's getting. She messed up. She stepped in the mud, now she's falling in it.
Do you know what's going on in Haiti?
Yeah, war.
What kind of war?
Just a war.
In what way? I mean, what they you know what happened today in Haiti?
So what? What if I know?
I'm just asking if you do.
I know, but if I talk about it, I don't like to talk.
What happened? Hold on. What happened today?
Talk about that.
I'm talking about
politics. No.
Which actress has the best ass in Hollywood?
I'm not answering that either, pal. Who are you from? Where do you get these questions?
What?
These are really stupid questions to be in an honorary celebration of the arts. These are bad questions, Bar.
Do you think the president was a draft dodger?
I'm finished.
Wow.
Wow, it didn't go well. Tell me what's going on in Haiti right now. War. No. Today.
What does it matter if I know? I know, but I'm not telling you.
You don't know. Gary Busey's a funny dude, man. Don't tell me he's for gay marriage.
No, he's a full-blooded Christian now.
But he didn't always lead the Christian lifestyle, correct?
No, I don't think he's leading the Christian lifestyle right now.
He struggles. He struggles.
What is he again? What are those things for a promise keeper?
Right.
Yeah, that's a promise keeper. Guys who promise to take care of their families.
Guy messed up, but now they promise to take care of their families. That's what it is.
Yeah. Is he married?
No.
No.
That's how he's keeping the promise.
The next family, he's going to take very good care of.
Yeah. He's something else. That's a funny dude.
Oh, I love him.
Yeah. Gary Garver ran into a bunch of other people that I think are funny, but I don't know if you would.
Let me hear. What's the list?
No. That, leave it at that one.
Oh, okay.
Not like Lou Ferrigno came here and, you know.
Sid Caesar.
What number was that?
I think it's the last one.
Sid Caesar is, for a lot of people who don't know, he's this old guy
who was on TV a million years ago?
Yeah, when they invented television, they put Sid Caesar on it.
Yeah. Now he's a big know-it-all. But he's a cool dude. I mean,
you know, think?
Yeah, he don't bother anybody. I mean, he was on live TV. I mean, you know, that's his claim to fame. That's how we're going to be when we're 100. People will walk down a red carpet somewhere, some guy will ask us annoying questions, and some radio guy will have to explain who we were.
Right.
Yeah, they were on, and, like, they used to say, like, anal, and they got thrown off the radio for it, but...
Yeah, they used to say things that nobody cares about now,
yeah.
But it used to get them in trouble.
Right.
Mr. Caesar, how are you? Do you think there are too many award shows?
Well, listen, the happy advice was bad.
Wow. You shouldn't even be going out when you sound like
that. Maybe he's doing that bit where he speaks a foreign language. Double talk or whatever that is. Double talk.
Were you offended when Janet Jackson's breast was exposed at the Super Bowl?
Well, some people would be, and some people I wouldn't be.
Do you think Mel Gibson only stirs up anti-Semitic feelings with his message in his Jesus movie?
Well, that's there's too many opinions already.
Yeah, we get involved in that.
Yeah. Which actress has the best female ass in Hollywood?
Imogene Cook. That was an ass.
You pick it up.
And do you think Beyonce has a big ass?
Yes, I don't answer.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Caesar.
Thank you.
What do you think of Howard Stern and his humor?
Well, hey, listen, free speech has got to be around.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Caesar.
All right.
Wow. Mr. Caesar. He is cool.
Mr. Caesar coming out for us.
Ringing your doorbell.
Mr. Caesar. I love that. Mr. Caesar.
Mr. Caesar. Mr. Caesar.
Whatever. I'm not a good chef.
Caesar out. Seacrest in. Give up. Seacrest out.
I got so much mail from... I think I should do the Gary Garver thing.
Yeah.
Where was this event?
I think it's called Night of 100 Stars, and the best thing I can figure out is it's people, celebrities who aren't big enough to be invited to the Oscars.
Yeah, that somehow goes on just before the Academy Awards, right?
I think it's like an Oscar-watching party.
Yeah.
Yeah, me and Robin were invited to an Oscar-watching party, and I was about to go, and I just said, it's a loser party.
It's funny, though, because people get dressed up to go watch TV.
I know.
You wore a gown.
You wore
I'm
a gown.
I'm saying it's funny.
Beth was going to wear something, and I was going to get my suit on.
They
and I went,
dress you, send you a car.
And then I came to my senses.
My wife
you
bought
didn't
a new
come
dress.
To your senses. You were going to go.
Yeah.
You know what, though? I really didn't want to go from the beginning because I told Beth, I go, I don't like going to that stuff. I mean, it's a bunch of people.
This is the second year in a row you've almost gotten there.
I know. Well, she wants to go so bad, but I'm like, oh, my God. She goes, well, we'll just have some cocktails, you know. And
yeah, it's free food.
Mm-hmm. She just has this dress she wants to wear, and I don't go anywhere really nice. So.
Right, so she very rarely gets to dress up like
right.
that. That's and the other thing. I had a gown I hadn't used. I said, I'll get to wear it.
I don't mind getting dressed up and having a nice night out, but I didn't need to do it in front of reporters. You know what I mean? I'll go to a nice
right.
restaurant. I love that.
But it was a riot. How is she going to see Liza? Come
All
on.
Right. So Gary Garver ran into Gary Busey.
Oh.
Who's always funny. And this time we told Gary Garver, our reporter, we said, when you see celebrities, ask them if they know what's going on in Haiti.
Ah.
And we made Gary Garver read everything about Haiti so that he would be, like, so that he could follow up and go, no, you're not right. This is what's going on in Haiti.
So he had to study Haiti
yeah.
in order to do this interview.
Yeah, so the Haiti thing, you'll see why Gary Garver tries to get into it.
All right.
Because he knows everything about Haiti now. We made him read everything. All right, here we go. CD1.
Gary.
Yeah.
Hey.
What do you need?
Do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews? Do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews?
No. Making movies everywhere, that's the idea. Get out of the greed pocket, the money game, and the game of exploitation and the game of betrayal. Give the money to the people making the story to put it on the screen to give messages of hope and love and spirituality. And wherever that country we do that in, they do that in, all of us do that in, is the right place to be.
Are you for or against stem cell research and why?
I'm for it.
You're for it? How about you, Gary?
I'm for it, too.
Do you support the president's plan to ban a homosexual marriage?
I have nothing to say about that. That has to do with the Bible, and I'm very much a strong, full-blooded Christian. So I know how I feel about that, but I'm not going to get in the political arena with this question.
Do you think Martha Stewart is being made a government scapegoat?
No. She deserves what she's getting. She messed up. She stepped in the mud, now she's falling in it.
Do you know what's going on in Haiti?
Yeah, war.
What kind of war?
Just a war.
In what way? I mean, what they you know what happened today in Haiti?
So what? What if I know?
I'm just asking if you do.
I know, but why talk about it?
I don't like to talk.
What happened? Hold on. What happened today?
Talk about that.
You want to talk about it?
Talk about politics? No.
Which actress has the best ass in Hollywood?
I'm not answering that either, pal. Where are you from? Where do you get these questions?
What?
These are really stupid questions to be in an honorary celebration of the arts. These are bad questions, Barr.
You think the president was a draft dodger?
I'm finished.
Wow.
Wow, it didn't go well. Tell me what's going on in Haiti right now.
War.
No. Today.
What does it matter if I know? I know, but I'm not telling you.
You don't know. Gary Busey's a funny dude, man. Doesn't sound like he's for gay marriage.
No, he's a full-blooded Christian now.
But he didn't always lead the Christian lifestyle, correct?
No, I don't think he's leading the Christian lifestyle right now.
He struggles. He struggles.
What is he again? What are those things for a promise keeper?
Right.
Yeah, that's promise keeper. Guys who promise to take care of their families.
Guys messed up, but now they promise to take care of their families. That's what it is.
Yeah. Is he married?
No.
That's
how he's keeping the promise.
The next family, he's going to take very good care of.
Yeah, he's something else. That's a funny dude.
Oh, I love him.
Yeah. Gary Garver ran into a bunch of other people that I think are funny, but I don't know if you would.
Let me hear. What's the list?
No, leave it at that one.
Oh, okay.
But like Lou Ferrigno came here and, you know.
Sid Caesar.
What number was that?
I think it's the last one.
Sid Caesar is, for a lot of people who don't know, he's this old guy. Who was on TV a million years ago?
Yeah, when they invented television, they put Sid Caesar on it.
Yeah. Now he's a big know-it-all. But he's a cool dude. I mean, you know.
You think?
Yeah, he don't bother anybody. He was on live TV. I mean, you know, that's his claim to fame. That's how we're going to be when we're 100. People will walk down a red carpet somewhere, some guy will ask us annoying questions, and some radio guy will have to explain who we were.
Right.
Yeah, they were on, and, like, they used to say, like, anal. And they got thrown off the radio for it, but
yeah, they used to say things that nobody cares about now,
yeah.
But it used to get them in trouble.
Right.
Mr. Caesar, how are you? Do you think there are too many award shows?
Well, listen, the happy events was bad.
Like 100
wow.
Years.
You shouldn't even be going out when you sound like
maybe he's doing that bit where he speaks a foreign language. Double talk or whatever that is. Double talk.
Were you offended when Janet Jackson's breast was exposed at the Super Bowl?
Well, some people would be, and some people I wouldn't.
Do you think Mel Gibson only stirs up anti-Semitic feelings with his message in his Jesus movie?
Oh, that's there's too many opinions already.
Yeah, we get involved in that.
Which actress has the best female ass in Hollywood?
Imogene Cooker. That was an ass.
You pick it up.
And do you think Beyonce has a big ass?
Just right on that show.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Caesar.
Thank you.
What do you think of Howard Stern and his humor?
Well, hey, listen, free speech has got to be around.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Caesar.
All right.
Wow. Mr. Caesar. Is cool.
Mr. Caesar coming out for us.
Ringing
Mr.
endorsement.
Mr. Caesar. I love that. Mr. Caesar.
Mr. Caesar. Mr. Caesar.
Whatever. I'm not a Caesar.
Caesar out. Seacrest in. Give up. Seacrest out.
Seacrest out?
Seacrest out.
There it is. Seacrest out.
Yeah, it's not just Seacrest out.
Right.
Thank my monkey. All right, Gary Garver was out at the NAACP Awards, and he interviewed a couple of people. Gary Garver, a reporter out in Los Angeles, works for KLSX. He ran into Wayne Brady from the Wayne Brady Show.
Oh, that's still on?
Yeah, it's winding down. Probably an important show like that's being taken off the air. Not because of anything he said, but because nobody watches it.
He was perfectly clean.
Hey Wayne, can I ask a couple questions?
You know,
Wayne, hang on. A couple questions. Are you upset by Clear Channel's suspension of Howard Stern?
Not at all. Well, no, yes, so far. I really haven't thought about it.
He was pretty definite.
Right. Now he's going to think.
Well, he knows we goof on his show and he probably hates us, but I think he also thinks, you know.
He's rethinking the whole free speech
thing. Yeah.
So why would I be upset about it? I
want censorship
at all.
A lot of people want to support us, but they can't because we goof on them.
Yeah, so I'd like to defer that, but it's Howard.
Yeah.
No, what I'm saying is I haven't thought about it. It is censorship, and I'm hoping that what will end up happening is it'll be either reversed or at least talk about it. You know, that it seems to be such a sudden move. It's like, bam, you know what happened. Let's at least open the dialogue because, you know, one day it's that, the next day it's a talk show on TV, the next day it's this movie.
I gotta admit, it's nice that the guy's defending me, but he is boring.
I don't even know what he's talking about.
He's saying that one day it'll be Howard Stern and the next day.
He's like, open up a dialogue.
Yeah.
What?
He's a weird guy. What does open the dialogue mean? How's he going to open a dialogue?
See, that's well, he's used to dialogue. He was talking to about one person on the TV show.
See, here's a guy trying to help us, and we're going to goof him.
Well, it's bad when a person defending you makes completely no sense.
Yeah. Well, that's been pretty much the problem.
Yeah, all along.
So I hope we can at least open up a dialogue and see what happens.
Just one more question. What's the most racially insensitive thing someone's ever said to you?
Actually, you know what? I've had the fortune of avoiding any idiots that might stand in my path, either that or completely forgetting anything that I've said.
Have you ever had sex with a white person?
And you're an ass.
Thank you.
And you're an ass.
I think he's married to an Asian woman, actually.
Yes, he is.
So he had sex with an Asian. Yeah.
Well, we don't know who he's had sex with other than that, though. He probably has been around the world.
Why should they ask you in person if you had sex with a white person?
I don't know.
And why is someone going to ask for that?
Well, I think it's important for us to know who's having sex with her, quite frankly.
Yeah.
We're trying to open a dialogue.
Hey, man, we're just trying to open a dialogue with you. Well, thank you, Mr. Brady, for your support, I think.
Try to keep supporting us.
Maybe if you can make up a song and sing it in Washington in support of you.
Oh, you know, that would have been a good thing to do. Could you sing a song about...
Yeah, on the spot.
Howard Stern News.
Yeah, we didn't know he'd be there, quite frankly.
Howard Stern got taken off of your channel.
Gary Garver then met Lou Gossett Jr., the famous actor.
Mr. Gossett, how you doing?
Good to see you too, buddy.
Who do you support for president?
Hillary Clinton. Yep.
Are you for gay marriages?
Yes.
Do you have an African name?
An African name is Kofi. Kofi Ababa.
How about a Muslim name?
Kofi Ababa.
Do you think the Janet Jackson breast-bearing incident is a racist situation since Justin Timberlake seems to be getting off scot-free?
Did you say Madonna?
I said Janet Jackson.
I thought you said Madonna.
Was he out with Artie before this interview?
High altitude.
I guess Lou Gossett is crazy.
Wow.
That was funny.
Gary Garver then ran into Emmitt Smith, who is a football player.
Isn't
he like an old football player?
Well, he's still playing, isn't he? He's going to be on Dallas, and then they traded him last year because he is getting a little behind.
Not only a football player, but he's a Hall of Famer.
Yeah,
and
he's a great one.
Winding down his career now.
Emmitt, can I ask you a couple questions?
Big fan of you. How you doing?
Are you playing next year?
That is the intent.
Yeah.
Cool. With Arizona?
Yes. Who do you support for president?
Who do I support for president? You know what? I haven't even thought much about it right now. I know they all going through their political stuff right now, and it's a bunch of showmanship going on right now. Mm-hmm. So when the time comes when they get down to have one-on-one debates, then that's when I tune in.
Yeah. No need to think about it right now.
Right. Maybe you would like to select who's in the debate?
Do you condemn Janet Jackson for showing her breasts?
You know what? There's a lot more worse things in America going on right now than Janet Jackson showing her breasts.
A lot more worse things.
Yeah.
In some people's glamour.
What's the most racially insensitive thing someone has ever said to you?
Go home, nigger. How about that one?
Hmm. Do you believe that Jason Williams should go to prison?
Well, I think it's not up to me right now to determine whether or not the man should go to prison. Yeah, yeah, obviously he has did something fairly wrong, but his time is going to be justified in due time. And
he has did something fairly wrong.
Also, I'd like to apologize right now for saying that to Emmett Smith at a Giant Cowboys game.
Yeah, that was wrong of you.
I was drunk. I didn't mean it.
That was so racially insensitive.
He has did something wrong. He has did something very wrong at this time.
Yeah.
But,
fairly wrong.
Fairly wrong. I mean, he shot a guy. He has did something very, very wrong at this time.
Fairly wrong.
Fairly wrong.
Fairly wrong. He did something very wrong.
I might have to listen to this again. He has did something.
Fairly wrong.
Up to me to determine whether or not he go to prison or not. I may go to jury.
Are you upset by Clear Channel suspension of Howard Stern?
You know what? Like I said, there are a lot more worse things in the world going on than to be worried about what Howard Stern is saying. And there's a lot more problems. They got worse stuff on television. And now they're just talking about radio. So and you can tune in when you want to. You don't have to. So it's not even my decision. I know what I listen to.
You listen to Howard?
He's right about that.
No, he's saying you can tune into whatever you want to, but we're saying they're not letting us tune into what we want to. He's missing the entire friggin' point.
No, what he's saying is that the government shouldn't be even paying attention to that. There's a lot worse things.
No, I think he's saying he can't be paying attention to that right now.
I think I'm right.
You know what? The interpretations of the words of Emmett Smith could be going on forever.
The only thing we know he said for sure was he has did something fairly wrong.
I got to hear that line again. We might have to isolate that. You got to play that once in a while.
Emmett, can I ask a couple questions? Big fan of you.
How you doing?
Gary Garber's no better. Big fan of you.
Big fan of you.
Big fan of yours. He's another mom of mine. He has no command of the English language. I'm a big fan of you.
Couple of English professors talking to each other.
Playing next year?
That is the intent.
Yeah. Cool, with Arizona?
Yes.
Who do you support for president?
Who do I support for president? You know what? I haven't even thought much about it right now. I know they all going through their political stuff right now, and it's a bunch of showmanship.
He hasn't thought about a lot of that.
Going on right now. So when the time comes when they get down to have one-on-one debates, that's when I tune in.
Do you condemn Janet Jackson for showing her breasts?
You know what? There's a lot more worse things in America going on right now than Janet Jackson showing her breasts.
What's the most racially insensitive thing someone has ever said to you?
Go home, nigger. How about that one?
Do you believe that Jason Williams should go to prison?
Well, I think it's not up to me right now to determine whether or not the man should go to prison. Yeah, yeah, obviously he has did something fairly wrong, but...
He has did something fairly wrong.
Yeah. His time is going to be justified in due time, and it's not...
His time is going to be justified in due time.
He's great.
Yeah. Emmett's my favorite guy to interview.
Wow.
I mean, I wouldn't be goofing on him if he was here.
No.
He'd kick my ass.
No, he's only about 5'10". He's a short guy.
Yeah, I can handle him.
Powerful.
Yeah, a little. Yeah.
He'd move upon me like a cheetah. And rip my throat out.
Great running back. Cost me a lot of money in the early 90s.
To me to determine whether or not he go to prison or not. I may go to jury.
Are you upset by Clear Channel suspension of Howard Stern?
You know what? Like I said, there are a lot more worse things in the world going on than to be worried about what Howard Stern is saying. And there's a lot more problems. They got worse stuff on television. And now they're just talking about radio. So, and you can tune in when you want to. You don't have to. So it's not even my decision. I know what I listen to.
You listen to Howard ever?
No. Thanks, Howard.
Thanks, Howard, yes.
Thanks, Hal.
Thanks, Howard.
I'm a big fan of you, and thanks, Howard.
Gary Garver's nervous when he does this. He's always seems to get his life punched out. Thank you, Howard.
If Gary Garver and Emmett Smith had a talk show, I'd watch it every night.
Yep. See, they're asking the wrong people to be on talk shows.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're asking people who can talk.
They're all these articulate guys.
Yeah, what's the problem here?
Yeah. How's this? It's been a lot of political discussion and debate about me over the weekend. We got to play.
Yeah, I'd like to hear that.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
See if anybody is making sense out there.
Gary Garver, we played this last week, but it's worth playing one last time. Plus, Artie didn't hear it. This is a good one, too. This is Gary Busey.
Oh, yeah.
With Gary Garver.
Mm-hmm.
End it. Cat.
Wait, wrong one. Let's end it again. I can hear that again, too.
Gary.
Yeah! Hey. What do you need?
Hey, do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews? Do you think filmmakers who make films in Canada to save money are hurting American movie crews?
No, no. Making movies everywhere, that's the idea. Get out of the green pocket, the money game, and the game of exploitation and the game of betrayal. Give the money to the people making the story to put it on the screen to get messages of hope and love and spirituality. And wherever that country we do that in, they do that in, all of us do that in, is the right place to be.
Are you for or against stem cell research and why?
I'm for it.
For, how about you, Gary?
I'm for it, too.
Do you support the president's plan to ban a homosexual marriage?
I have nothing to say about that. That has to do with the Bible, and I'm very much a strong, full-blooded Christian. So I know how I feel about that, but I'm not going to get in the political arena with this question.
Do you think Martha Stewart is being a government scapegoat?
No. She deserves what she's getting. She messed up. She stepped in the mud, now she's falling in it.
Do you know what's going on in Haiti?
Yeah, a war.
What kind of war?
Just a war.
In what way? I mean, what they did. You know what happened today?
We made Gary Garver read everything about Haiti before we interviewed Gary Busey. And then just a few questions, because now Gary Garver's an expert on Haiti. He's hammering away.
In Haiti?
So what? What if I know?
I'm just asking if you do.
No, I know, but I talk about it. I don't like to talk.
What happened? Hold on, what happened today?
Talk about that.
Talk about
politics, no.
Which actress has the best ass in Hollywood?
I'm not answering that either, pal. Who are you from? Where do you get these questions?
What?
These are really stupid questions to be at an honorary celebration of the arts. These are bad questions, pal.
You think the president was a draft dodger?
I'm finished.
Finished.
Busey out.
What intelligent question should you be asking Gary Busey?
Back to Haiti. For 1 minute.
He has did something fairly wrong.
A classic.
That's good. I love that.
Oh, that's amazing.
Hi, Pitch Eric, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard, good morning. How are you?
Fine.
You know, I did see you this weekend. I demonstrated in front of the radio station this weekend.
What radio station?
Your radio station on 57th Street. I had to thank Mary Ann and Joey Booth and Beetlejuice for coming down to the demonstration.
He's such an idiot that he stood outside the radio station. I think he's putting me on, but he stood outside
the radio
station.
I'm not putting
on. Why would you protest the radio station? They're trying to keep me on.
No, I'm protesting what happened with the FCC.
Yeah, but why don't you go to the FCC and protest? Don't protest the radio station.
Yeah, why don't you go to the radio station?
Because I want to show my point of view in New York when I think of the FCC.
All right, Ian, you're on the air.
All right.
Yes, Ian.
Howard, how are you? Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, Saturday Night Live happened to do a great cartoon about you.
Yeah, our friend Bob Smigel did an FCC cartoon. I heard about it. I didn't get to see it.
Oh, yeah. Somebody's got to send me the tape. I don't happen to have a tape, but it was hilarious.
What was it?
Apparently, it started by somebody drawing a figure of Powell Strunn, the head of the FCC. And as they started drawing him, as they got to the crotch area, they kind of drew him with no balls.
Right.
So after that happened, they basically said, after Howard Stern is off the air, your kids will be watching cartoons like this. And they showed Elmer Fudd blowing up a rabbit's hole with about 12 shots of his shotgun and all kind of violent things.
Yeah, I got to see it. I'll take a look. I heard it was funny.
It was hilarious. Then after the whole thing, they panned to you, the illustrator, laughing hysterically, saying that was kind of fun.
Oh, good. I want to see it because Bob's real bright and he's funny and he's probably the best thing on Saturday Night Live right now. So Gary Garver went out to the TV Land Awards, whatever those are. TV Land's a TV station, right?
Yeah, it plays old television shows.
Yeah. Gary Garver was out there at the TV Land Awards show. And a lot of people are confused because he started asking them, what do you think of Howard Stern? Well, Sybil Shepherd's not confused. She just hates me.
Oh. Yeah. I don't even understand the TV Land Awards. These are shows that were already done.
Well, that's a chance for a lot of these
older folks to give each other awards.
For what? They already got awards for
shows. But they haven't gotten awards in a real long time.
I see.
Like Cybill Shepherd, when's the last time anyone looked at us?
Hey, how you doing, Ms. Shepherd?
Hi, good.
Do you think the death of John Ritter will cast a shadow on this year's awards?
It will certainly will cast a shadow for me. I love John Ritter. That was one of my favorite shows.
This chick used to be the hottest chick I ever
what
saw.
What happened?
Got old. She got ugly.
What the? But she can't even talk.
She got retarded.
You know what I caught recently on cable? The Heartbreak Kid.
Oh, she was beautiful.
Unbelievable.
Oh.
On television, that Lucille Ball.
Who do we support for president?
John Kerry.
Are you for gay marriage?
Absolutely.
Are you upset by Claire Chow's suspension of Howard Stern?
No, I hate him. I can't stand him.
You can't stand Howard?
No, except that he does mention my name once in a while, and I appreciate that.
Why do you hate him?
He's just sexist and obnoxious and sleazy.
Think so?
That's my opinion.
Really?
I wouldn't want to go out with him or make out with him or anything.
Thanks a lot, Michelle.
I don't think we should be in Iraq.
You don't think we should be in Iraq either?
We should never have been gone to Iraq.
Thanks.
I should date her. Sounds like she wants it.
She would date you in a second.
Yep. I could definitely get her into her pants.
So who's asking at this point to make out with her?
I know. She's, well, I wouldn't make out with him. Hey, honey, I wouldn't make out with you either.
She's just waiting for the invitation. Who was even talking about making out?
Didn't she used to, like, make out with Burt Reynolds?
And Elvis and everybody, wasn't it?
All those sleazy dudes. She's real bitter and angry because I think guys really effed her over.
Well, you know, she was beautiful and, you know.
And stupid.
She believed a lot of stuff that she was told.
See, who is that movie director that she used to be?
Peter Bogdanovich.
Yeah. Even, he's an ugly troll and even he screwed her over. Even he dumped her ass. Right?
She didn't get to capitalize on that great beauty. It just got used.
Now she's all
washed up.
Washed up. But she's on the right side politically. At least she ain't voting for Bush.
Yeah, that we can commend her for.
You know, Eartha Kitt, I wonder if anybody remembers old Eartha
Kitt. She was Catwoman, one of the Catwomen in the original Batman show.
Yeah, she was the original Catwoman.
Miss Kitt.
How are you doing?
Hi. How you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Who will you support for president?
Bush.
Yeah?
Jesus,
I don't think you can stop what is going on in midair. You have to continue with it until we, the people, as well as the presidency, gets our act together.
Yeah, because she's like all confused. Wait till you hear her opinions on me.
Okay.
It's like all over the place.
I'm Janet Jackson for Show Brass.
Yes, because it's in bad taste at that particular time. It could have been any other time except for when the family is watching.
What is the most racially insensitive thing someone has ever said to you?
Racial insensitive thing?
Yeah, someone has ever said to you.
She's beautiful, but she's just a nigger.
Do you have a Muslim name?
No, my name is Eartha Kitt, and I intend to keep it that way.
Why do you think Jews have been hated throughout history?
Misunderstood. Because we're different, and any of us who are different think differently, say, in the absolute norm, then of course we're going to be criticized.
Do you believe Michael Jackson ever molested a child?
I don't want to think that way, and so therefore I don't want to believe it. So I will say no. I don't think he has done any harm to anybody. I think he's not the brightest kid in the world to be behaving with children when he's been constantly told not to do what he's doing, because no matter what he's doing, as innocent as it may be, he's going to be accused and be taken advantage of financially.
Have you ever had sex with a white person?
Have I been what?
Have you ever had sex with a white person?
All the time, darling. But I have no race, creed, or color, so I don't think of it in those terms.
And are you upset by Claire Chow's suspension of Howard Stern?
They should have done that a long time ago.
You don't like Howard?
Well, it's not a matter of not liking Howard. I think those kind of programs have us come to the now where people like Janet Jackson is being caused the thing to be put off the air.
What? She's thinking that because of Joe, Janet Jackson is forced to show her boo because I've stepped up the level.
I see. I was like, well, what? What do you have to do with Janet?
But wait, then she does a whole reversal that she's for freedom of speech. Wait, what?
But we have to censor ourselves. We should not wait for a government or the community to censor us. We should do that ourselves as artists. But Howard Stern is Howard Stern, and this is a country that should have freedom of speech.
Yeah, that's
it's a matter of timing. You know, it's a matter of where you are and have your freedom of speech and what you're saying within the boundaries of that freedom of speech. But sometimes I think we have carry our freedom a little too far. We have and we should have respect for that. As
we should have a border on our free speech.
A border.
They need a murderer of free speech. I'm for free speech, but we need to have not so much of it.
We should have a border on our free speech.
It's a very bad thing, free speech, but...
we should have our free speech, but only in certain places.
Americans, and as a human being.
When you're behind locked doors.
As a citizen.
Thanks a lot, Miss Kit.
Okay.
All right, Miss Kit.
It should have been done a long time ago.
Should have been Misfit.
Miss Kit, if you're nasty.
Right. A lot of people are just confused. Here's Gary Coleman.
Gary Coleman?
Yeah.
Are you upset by Clear Channel's suspension of Howard Stern?
No, I'm not.
Why?
I think self-censorship is good. I don't want government censorships.
He thinks the government had nothing to do with Clear Channel taking
it
up.
This is why they're getting away with it. Everybody is thinking it was just a company decision.
Yeah. No. I was with them 10 years.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, after Janet Jackson getting hauled in front of Congress, then they decided.
Yeah, when the government said, we're cracking down, this company said, we're going to get in line.
Clear Channel was making a fortune with me. And besides, the only reason they threw me off at this point was because I came out against Bush. I know it, and everyone knows it. Happened to 7-0 broadcast work for Clear Channel.
Right, but see, that happened very quietly, and it looks like you're being taken off for a proper speech.
Well, Rush Limbaugh doesn't agree with that, so, because he knows so much. And George Lopez, the comedian, is a big fan of ours, but...
He agrees with it, too.
No, but he doesn't understand the issue. That's the problem.
Are you upset by Clear Channel's suspension of Howard Stern?
I am. You know, I'm a huge fan of not only of Howard's, but also of free speech. I just think it's a really tough time. I mean, and it's as much as I love Howard, I mean, I support him wherever he's going to end up. And you know, I'm not in favor of him being cut loose from six places. But it was a mistimed stunt and a prank that, you know, anybody that's creative is going to pay for.
A mistimed stunt?
So he can say this is referring to Janet Jackson's stunt.
I don't know.
Anyone creative is going to pay for. He thinks I said something.
That's what I'm wondering. Does he think you did something, or is it the Janet Jackson thing?
I don't know. For Glenda, you know Gary Garber doesn't ask a follow-up.
Yeah, Gary's not even listening.
No. He's just sweating, hoping he doesn't get punched. Oh, man. So, I don't know. People are very, very confused about what is exactly going on.
This is the problem, that it's never going to be explained to the press what happened.
It's just that I'm going to be thrown off the air and everyone's going to think I said something wrong.
Right.
That's what it's going to come down to, and nobody's going to care anyway, but whatever. We got a lot of email. I see. Yeah. So we sent Gary Garver out to the MTV Awards. He did a couple of interviews. What's B2K? Is that a rap band?
Yes.
Are they any good?
I don't know.
I wonder, half these rap bands you never even hear about.
You know, the names are just flying at you these days because everybody lasts about 2 minutes.
Isn't that Eminem's posse, B2K? Or is that D12?
I don't remember. I think he's D12.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
B2K. I remember Y2K. That was the whole problem with that.
Yeah, that was a bad deal.
And those guys were a mess.
I didn't like them.
What's B2K? We just took another one of those rap bands you don't even know about?
Right.
Yeah, okay.
But I hear, you know what? There's a band that I hear about them all the time, but I don't know any of their music.
What about R2-D2? What happened to him? He was good. I liked him. R2!
He is so over.
R2! R2, I need help over here. Shut up.
He's putting out a greatest hits.
How you doing, man?
How you doing?
Who are you guys?
Theus from B2K, and that's J-Book.
Theus and J-Book?
Yes. You don't realize who these people are?
Just trying to make it clear. Keep it real.
You guys support gay marriage?
I'm not
against any of it. If that's what you want to do, then that's what you want to do. I'm not God to judge nobody. You guys like Bush?
No. No.
Should retarded people be sterilized?
Who?
Should retarded people be sterilized?
Oh, nah. Like killed?
Yeah, so killed, you know, sterilized where they can't have kids.
Nah. Nah.
Is oral sex cheating?
No. Nah, it's not.
Do you agree with Bill Cosby when he thinks that too many black people wear baggy pants and speak in a slang that no one understands?
I mean, that's his opinion on black people, but mine is, if that's what they want to do, then that's what they want to do. Feel the same way.
What?
Feel the same way.
Yeah. And what, you guys are what now?
B2K.
B2K.
And J-Book.
What's your name?
J-Book, Lil Fizz.
That's what, thanks a lot.
No, it's not Fizz, it's Lil Fizz.
Little Fist?
Little Fizz? Or
I think it's Little Fizz.
Like Little Fizz.
Black people, are, like rap guys, are becoming like Indians. You know, they're like Brook, you know, Babbling Brook. Little Fist.
Makes no sense.
All right, let's see. I see you talked to Jessica Biel, but that's not good. Brittany Murphy's no good?
It was okay. You can
okay.
Try if you want.
Jessica Biel was no good?
Jessica Biel, what was she in? Flashdance, right?
She's Flashdance. No, no, no. That's this is the girl from Seventh Heaven, right?
Right.
And Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
No, I don't care about her.
Oh, I like the Flashdance chick better.
Brittany Murphy's got a giant head.
She does.
A little skinny body with a big giant head.
She is a butterface.
Can't put my money on. I can't take my phone.
He can't get that question out.
No, nothing I'm aware of at this moment.
Hey, Brittany,
I have a flight in the morning.
Go ahead. Do you support gay marriage?
Yes.
Do you like Bush?
How do you mean that, friend?
George Bush.
There's many different ways to take that one.
Well, yeah, any way you want to take it, sweetheart.
Yeah, you take it wherever you want to go.
Take it right in his room over here with me.
I have on
my clothes that come from my closet, but they happen to be made by Dolce & Gabbana, but they were from my closet.
Hey, is oral sex cheating?
I definitely think so, yeah.
Yeah?
Hmm. All right. Nicole Richie, who will be on this show soon. Who's on the cover of some men's magazine. I can't think of the name.
FHM?
Stuff, maybe?
Stuff? I think it's Stuff.
And I got to tell you something. I can't wait for her to come in here. Because first of all, it is the best magazine cover, the hottest magazine cover I've ever seen. And I'm wondering...
How does she do it?
How airbrushed is that? I mean...
What are you talking about? Where's the magazine cover?
I don't know. I don't know where it is. I brought it home with me yesterday, but...
Oh, that good.
Yeah. But either they stuck her head on someone else's body... Or they electronically stretched her. Oh, there it is.
The whole spread's amazing.
I mean, it's the hottest spread I've ever seen.
Let me see.
First of all, there's the cover. Okay.
Wow, she looks like her partner, Paris.
Better. Then, hold on. Well, I got to find it now. God damn it. Oh, here it is. I mean, I've never seen more beautiful pictures. Now, does she have legs like that?
Absolutely not.
I mean, that can't be her. I mean, she's a cute girl, but she's
unless
not.
Unless she did something, because every picture I see of her, you know, that's a candid shot.
Look at this one in the miniskirt. I mean,
she looks so
she's
mad.
A supermodel. No, she's a supermodel.
I'm saying the candid shots I see of
her.
Oh,
that ain't no candid shot. They stretched that one, too. Yeah.
We were saying in the office yesterday, she's got a cute face, but she's a little bit like doughy.
Yeah.
Not in these pictures. She is toned and ripped. Look at this.
Yeah.
There's no way. Well, she was like that then. I don't know when they took those pictures.
Took him on another planet. In the bizarro world.
Maybe, you know, traveling around in that trailer did something to her.
I don't like that they airbrush chicks.
Yeah, because it used to be the real girl, right?
Well, maybe if she walks in here and she looks like that, I'm going to ask her to marry me.
All right.
All right? So there might be a marriage proposal. I told you I'd never get married, but if she looks that good...
You'll marry her.
Marry her. She's rich. And she
is
looks
she
that
really?
Good.
Do you think Lionel Richie is giving her his money?
Yes. Yes, I do.
She seems to have grown up. Rich.
She's very wealthy.
She lived at their house.
But
not to give her money at this point would be bad.
Yeah, I mean, she would be. That's like taking your dog and sending it out in the woods and say, go live.
Right, how's she going to survive?
Now, yeah. Is she a white chick?
She's mixed and Hispanic.
Yeah, I wasn't sure because it's not Lionel's daughter, right?
Right, it's the Sheila E.'s brother's daughter.
No, she's saying not necessarily. It's one of three guys. She's not even sure who her real father is.
Oh, you mean he might not even be the guy?
Yeah, they don't know. She says she doesn't know in this interview. We're going to interview her, but anyway, here's her interview with Gary Garver.
Nicole, how you doing?
Hi, how are you?
How you doing?
Good to see you.
Who will you vote for in November?
Who am I what?
Vote for in November.
Who will I vote for? I don't want to say right now because I haven't made up my mind.
Do you support gay marriage?
Yes, I do. Yes.
Do you think Artie Lang is out of control?
Do I think Artie Lang is out of control? I don't know. I don't like commenting on that stuff.
Is oral sex cheating?
What?
Is oral sex cheating?
Is oral sex cheating? It really depends on who you're married to and, like, you know, if they consider it cheating or not.
What do you consider it?
I would, if my boyfriend had oral sex with another girl, I would, yes, consider it cheating.
And should retarded people be sterilized?
What? No!
Thanks a lot, Nicole.
Bye.
Wow.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Maybe we should start asking if retarded people should be killed.
D12 is on here. That's Eminem's posse, but I see it's not that good. You haven't circled it.
No, it wasn't.
Wasn't good?
Didn't turn you on.
Sean Wayans is annoyed. That's the guy. He's one
really?
Of the Wayans brothers. Yeah, he gets kind of, he's just kind of cranky.
Sean, who do you blame for the problems in the Middle East, the Arabs or the Jews?
You're insane, and I wouldn't even answer that question. What else?
Do you support gay marriage?
I think that whatever one chooses to do is his business, and, you know, if it makes him happy, cool.
Hey, do you agree with Bill Cosby when he thinks that too many black people wear baggy pants and speak in a slang that no one understands?
I think Bill Cosby created mushmouth, and he should look at his own tape.
Should retarded people be sterilized?
What?
Should retarded people be sterilized?
No, that's crazy.
You think Artie Lang is out of control?
That's another weird question. What else you got? How about White Chicks, June 23rd?
Thanks.
All right. Right down to it.
Plug in.
You want to hear from Julia Roberts' brother, Eric?
Sure.
He just said something nice about us.
Aw.
Hey, Eric, how you doing?
What's your name?
Jerry.
Eric.
Eliza,
hi.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you too.
Do you support freedom of speech?
I sure do, man.
Do you think the FCC should leave Howard Stern alone?
Absolutely.
Do you think that Bush should be impeached?
Yes.
Absolutely.
Would you say my name is Eric Roberts and I support Howard Stern? If the FCC doesn't like it, they can kiss my ass.
I'm Eric Roberts, I support Howard Stern, and if the FCC doesn't like it, they can kiss my ass.
Thanks a lot.
There you go.
He did it.
Beautiful. He did it. Now can you say...
What else can we get him?
What else can we say? So I like that because he is willing to speak up. The other guy who's willing to speak out is Eddie Van Halen. In Guitar World magazine, they interview him this month, and he says, basically, I mean, I'm summing up a long sort of paragraph, but he basically says, I don't like what the FCC is doing to Howard Stern.
Right, they should give up his case.
And I appreciate that because the more people who speak out in articles and in public forums, the more it helps us. It seems like whenever you interview a celebrity and you ask them, is Artie Lang out of control, no one wants a comment.
They don't want to get into it.
Well, I can pull
it. Everyone's talking about it. They just don't want to, get into it on, you know, public airwaves.
Clearly a hot issue.
If you want, I could pull together a little montage of... I don't know who that is.
Oh. Hey, do you think any of them there knew who it was?
I would have thought Sean would have known.
Yeah.
He's a big fan of the show, but everyone else seemed very baffled by it.
It doesn't seem like they know who I am. They just don't want to bother with the question.
Yeah.
They're just like, what?
Who's Kelly Hugh?
Oh, she's that Asian chick we had her in here once.
She was here, yeah.
Martial arts movies.
Yeah, she was good looking.
She's older but hot.
Yeah.
She's older?
Maybe I'm getting confused.
Yeah, no, she's the young one.
Oh, okay.
She was in, like, the Mummy movie.
I found that one incredibly annoying, actually. She's just one of those yellers. And, oh, my God.
The Scorpion King.
D12 wasn't good?
You know what? You can play it.
Black rap guys are always good.
I have almost no recollection of it, but I didn't circle it.
All right.
That's to say white rap guys aren't good?
White rap guys aren't real. We're rap guys. They're just faking it. They can speak.
D12! Hey, Matt, come on over, man. Hey, what the... What's up, man?
Hold on, man. Hey, let me ask a couple questions.
Hey, do you agree with Bill Cosby when he thinks that too many black people wear baggy pants and speak in a slang that no one understands?
No.
Hey, should retarded people be sterilized?
I don't know about that. My cousin is retarded.
Hey, is oral...
Pretty clean. He's pretty clean.
Is oral sex cheating?
No, not at all.
And do you think Artie Lang is out of control?
Artie Lang's out of control? Who's Artie Lang?
He's on the Howard Stern Show.
No, he's a good guy. Good guy.
There you go.
Keep doing what you're doing, Art.
They say it's okay, those guys. Gary Garver mixing it up with D12 in the house. Yeah, you're right. That wasn't a very good. But all right, there you have a couple of celebrity interviews. We'll try to bring in the famous people as well as the not-so-famous.
Yeah, what have the famous people been doing? Yeah. We haven't had very many of those.
They're avoiding Gary Garver.
Oh, man. I got to take a break. Oh, Gary Garver. Let me do this first. Gary Garver got kicked out of an event last night. Hey, Gary.
Hey, how you doing, Howard?
Hey, now. What happened?
I went down to this thing called the Golden Boot Awards over the weekend.
The Golden Vid Awards?
Golden Boot Awards.
Oh, Golden Boot Awards.
Yeah, it's a Western award show. They were honoring Val Kilmer and Sidney Poitier and Will Smith.
Val Kilmer, Sidney Poitier, and Will Smith.
Yeah.
This is the. I thought that was for people who star in Westerns.
I guess Will Smith and Val Kilmer starred in a couple. Well, if you call those Westerns, I don't know.
What Western was Val Kilmer in?
Wasn't he Doc Holliday and Wyatt Earp?
Oh, yeah.
He wasn't Doc Holliday, though.
Yes, he was.
He was?
Yeah, in one of them. There were two different movies.
Oh, right, because I thought that was Dennis Quaid.
Yeah, there were two movies, and he was in one of them.
Yeah, that was a pretty good movie.
And yeah, I guess he started with Kurt Russell in one of them.
Right, and Will Smith, I guess, was in the Wild Wild West, if you want to call that.
Oh, my God. I mean, how could you?
That was based on truth, wasn't it?
How could you honor that?
So, like, I get down there, and everything's cool, and then about 20 minutes after I get my media credential, this lady comes up and goes, do you work for the Howard Stern Show? And I go,
No.
No?
You don't?
No.
He doesn't.
Well, you're with Infinity Broadcasting and that L.A. station you're with.
Yeah. He doesn't directly work for us.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
Right.
But anyways, they said, whip out your ID, because I always use a different name to get into these things. And
Are you that well known?
I don't know. I guess so. I mean, well, I think it was from last year because it was the same award show that I got Mickey Rooney. Then he flipped out on me and everything. So
they threw you out.
Yeah, they just, you got to go. And I go, look at the questions. I said, they're not even bad, you know. And she goes, the lady goes, I'm a huge fan, but today I'm working, so you got to leave. She's a big fan of yours, but...
Now every television show has their version of Gary Garver or Stuttering John.
And those people are allowed in.
Yeah. Oh, it's cute.
Because it's going to be on The Tonight Show.
Yeah.
I mean, the questions weren't even bad. They were just about Bush and stem cell research, gay marriage, things like that.
Yeah.
You know, I asked her to look at the questions, and she wouldn't even look at them. She just said, you got to split. So, I believe.
You should have said you were with the Ali G Show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Ali G.
Yeah.
Oh, everybody can get an interview but us, Howard.
I know.
Don't let everybody in but us.
Everyone's so friggin' uptight.
I know. It's ridiculous, man. I just, you're talking about freedom of speech and Bush and all that. I mean, L.A. and the publicists here are just a-holes, man.
Gary Garver went to Jesse Jackson's 63rd birthday party.
Who was there?
Well, Don Cornelius, who hates us.
Of course.
And he ended up hating us again. Don Cornelius used to be the host of
Soul Train,
but he just gets angry.
I never knew he was such an angry guy.
So Cornelius, can I ask you a couple questions, please?
Really, no, thanks.
Feel any safer with Bush in office?
Huh?
You feel any safer with Bush in office?
I don't talk about politics, okay? All right.
What illegal drug was your favorite?
What?
What illegal drug was your favorite?
You, that's the question. Now get this mic out of my face, okay? You're a clown, okay? And I'm not in the mood to laugh, all right?
We never found him in that mood.
Yeah, you sound like you're in the mood to laugh, Don.
He hates us.
And all the times we've encountered him, he's not once been in the mood to laugh.
I don't know who else is on this tape. Let me see if I got a list. Let me see, wait.
Mr. Flint, how you doing?
That's Larry Flint.
Oh, Flint, okay.
The guy from Hustler magazine.
He ran into Earl Flynn.
Yeah.
Who's a big supporter of mine, except usually it's with naked beaver pictures next to it.
I'm a big supporter.
Right, he's always writing these great editorials, and then the picture next to it, you can get arrested.
It's like George Bush giving oral to John Kerry.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm really supportive of Howard Stern, and here's some bestiality.
He's the president of a donkey. Yeah.
Yeah, I want to be funny, but I'm coming out for Howard.
Yeah, it's like, it's a really beautiful editorial with a full page you know, a full-page dedication to me, and it goes, you know, Howard Stern has been going through this government fight, show of awe, and it's horrible. And then you turn the page, and there's like a fake picture of Cher naked, getting it from a donkey. You know what I mean?
This magazine supports Howard Stern. Now here's a cheerleader being suffocated.
Yeah, it's horribly bound and gagged.
Yeah, there's no gray area with us. We're for Howard. Now here's some defecation.
I'm always so happy that someone's for me, and then it's a guy who's showing suffocation.
You're attached to a page where there's like sexual murder. No.
Right, yeah, yeah. Some terrible pinning of underparts, like you're dissecting a frog.
Hustler's voice will not be swelled. We're for Howard. Now here's a donkey kicking a whore.
In the belly.
In the belly. And she's pregnant.
Yeah, it's always this glowing piece from Larry Flynt. You know, I was the victim of many government witch hunt.
Our First Amendment rights.
And our First Amendment rights have been taken away from us. And I just want to support Howard Stern. Then you turn the page, and it's like this woman bound and gagged with her own foot cut off and stuffed in her mouth so she can suffocate on
it. Right. Well, I just really object to those pictures there. You know, because it's science magazine.
We're for Howard Stern. Now how about a urine cocktail?
In science magazine, when you dissect a frog, they take his parts and they pin them, you know, into place so you can see in.
Yeah.
And that's what the picture next to your great rave is, a woman being pinned back.
We support, support Howard Stern.
Right. And now Bukkake.
A 50-page tribute to Bukkake.
Yes, it's our Bukkake issue.
Mr. Flynn, how you doing? Who do you support for president?
John Kerry, obviously.
Do you feel any safer with Bush in office?
No.
Do you support Bush's notion that same-sex marriages are wrong?
That's one area that I will agree with him on. I don't believe in amending the Constitution. I think.
Wow, this is. I'm
That's
shocked.
Funny. I was like, oh my God, he's going to agree with George Bush.
Well, what you talking about?
They should have the same.
That's a thing in Larry Flynt's quote.
That's called being completely paralyzed and confined to a wheelchair.
I just don't want that thing ending up on my microphone.
Yeah, same thing on like a high pitcher's throat.
Oh, hi, Puck.
Oh, Kelly Clark. This is Kelly Clark.
Who's my
Fire!
Same rights as everybody else, but I think marriage should be between a man and woman.
I'm shocked at Larry Flynt.
That's a tough impression to do.
Well, first you have to be underwater.
I don't know.
Yeah, first you have to get shot in the neck.
Really?
Can you do that, Fred? The... I guess not.
No,
you don't do an impression of Larry Flynt.
The best I do is that impression.
What legal drug was your favorite?
Probably Dilaudid. Do you say legal or illegal?
Illegal.
Yeah, we want to get that right.
My heroin.
Oh, you like that.
And who in Hollywood do you most like to have sex with?
Hey, douchebag, can't you see I'm in a chair?
I love that he's just, heroin.
I've already been there.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Flynt. God bless.
He's already been there.
Come on, my heroin.
What?
Get off my air holes.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
All I do to do it is just I make my mouth crooked. I have fun doing it.
Oh.
Get off my air holes.
Well, I do appreciate Mr. Flint's
support.
Is it Flynn or Flint?
It's Flint. Flint.
Larry Flint.
Larry what?
Flint.
Right.
F-L-Y-N-T. Flint.
I appreciate his support.
Thank you, buddy.
This is awesome.
The first right amendment.
Strange 63rd birthday party. Got Don Cornelius, Larry Flynt.
This is Jesse Jackson's party.
Yeah. Jesse Jackson, the activist.
Jesse Jackson was on Bill Maher's show. I was flipping the channel. I caught some of it. Couldn't understand a word he said.
Well, you know what
he
else is
weird? Kept getting applause.
And you know what else is weird? Like, you go to him, and then he filibusters. He doesn't shut up.
I think the mandates for a minority citizen should be at what they are.
and you want to tell him it's a comedy show.
Yeah, you're like, hey, come on, let's step it up a little.
Yeah, you know, learn to say things in 3 seconds. What's going on here? Gary just came in and said, how come you didn't play the rest of the Jesse Jackson 63rd birthday party interviews? I said, I don't know. My dad called and I got distracted.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't a conspiracy. The only guy I have left is Jesse Jackson, Mike Farrell from MASH, and Sherry Lansing, the head of Paramount Studios. You want to hear those quick and then I'll get James Van Prague in here?
Okay.
All right. This is Jesse Jackson.
Are you upset that you were never able to mount a serious challenge for president?
It's not true. In 1988, we got over 7.5 million votes. Matter of fact, we got more votes in 88 than Kerry got in 2004. That's serious. We got 1,300 delegates, and that's more delegates than the 8 we ran against Kerry got all combined. All those combined.
He's so funny. I don't know what he's talking about.
What?
He got more delegates than Kerry?
And more votes or something?
More votes than Kerry.
More votes in 2004. Meanwhile, we haven't had the election yet.
Delegates.
What's he talking about? What votes?
I don't know.
I'm just saying I got about 800 delegates. I got 1,300.
Freaking 100?
Don't you discount my freaking 100?
I got a freaking 100.
I got freaking 100.
Did you say 1,300?
1,300.
Oh. It's a serious campaign. And out of that campaign, Ron Brown became chair of DNC. Alexis Herman became a chief operating officer.
Wow. He became a chief?
I say.
Out of the 84 campaign, put on 2 million new voters, and that changed the makeup of the Senate in 1986. In 1989, Doug Wilder became governor of Virginia.
of Virginia?
Of a vagina?
Governor of a vagina?
It didn't quite agree, then we started by the city, Allen Merle, and then one of the gentlemen, Mr. Cass, got up and said a very inspiring prayer.
Dinkins, the mayor of New York, and out of those new voters, in 92 and 96, Dole and Bush got more white votes than Clinton. He got more white, black, and brown than they got. We helped change the world in so many ways, and so those are very successful campaigns. And now, there's a generation building up.
What an interview.
And now.
He only asked one question, right? He's still.
So far, yeah. Gary Garver's numb during it.
Huh?
Fun network.
Why do you black men follow the stereotype by having so many children out of wedlock?
Uh-oh.
Wow.
I'm sorry?
Why do black men follow the stereotype by having so many children out of wedlock?
You know, lots of people have children out of wedlock. And, of course, it's always a challenge for people to raise the children that they make. But I would like to think that we would do well to reach out to all people.
You got an answer for everything.
Yeah, this is something he had to think through.
Yeah, right. Set to experience, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah. Let me see.
Catch him off guard on that one.
I think Mike Farrell blows his lid.
Always.
Hey, Mr. Farrell, can I ask a couple questions?
Sure.
Who do you support for president?
John Kerry.
Of course. Do you feel any safer with Bush in office?
No, I think he's made us more, actually less safe. And I think his policies and his attitude, as expressed in his not only sending troops to Iraq and Afghanistan, but his attitude toward the rest of the world has made us...
I agree. So far, so good.
In dire straits. And I think that he has effectively put the Muslim world on notice that they are his targets. And I think that is a hideously stupid thing to do.
Do you support Bush's notion that same-sex marriages are wrong?
No, I don't. I think people's decisions on a personal level ought to be people's decisions on a personal level and ought to be honored as such.
What illicit drug was your favorite?
I never used drugs.
And who in Hollywood would you most like to have sex with?
Oh, are you the guy from his show again? I keep running into you. You know, you keep wanting to get people to say silly things. And I just, you know, it's really a waste of my time to do that.
But what else you
doing?
Mean,
you know, there were some serious questions here about Bush.
There were some serious ones, and I appreciated them, and I responded to them. But I don't want to respond to the silly ones.
What do you support Howard Stern?
I support his right to speak out freely, absolutely.
You don't like him?
I don't like what I hear from him. I don't care for the kind of cheap stuff that I think is cheap at any rate.
What about the First Amendment rights, you know?
I just said I support his right to speak freely.
Thank you.
All right.
I can live with that.
All right, but you don't agree with him completely because he said he also doesn't agree with sending troops into Afghanistan. And
oh, he doesn't?
Yeah.
No. That's too... I'm all for the Afghanistan thing.
Yeah.
You know. I'm for blowing up the entire Middle East. I mean, I'm way out there. Let's not risk anybody's life.
Mike Farrell is not on the same side of this as you are.
I'm into sinking the Middle East into the whatever sea they have.
Bombing it back.
Back into whatever ocean
into
is there.
The Ice Age.
We clearly can get rid of the whole Middle East without having one American die.
Yeah.
We should do it.
I don't know why we're doing it this way. It's just dumb.
Maybe it's live. They really don't work.
Satellites. Gary Garver was out in Los Angeles at the... Where did he get all these models from? Is this from the American Music Awards? They wouldn't be there. Models wouldn't be there.
No, it was some Victoria's Secrets event.
Oh, okay. So at the Victoria's Secrets event, he first interviewed Gisele Bündchen.
Oh!
The one who goes out with Leonardo DiCaprio. And I got to tell you something. It's really interesting to hear these chicks...
Because when you just see him, you imagine all kinds of wonderful things.
Giselle's like the hottest chick in the world, but when you hear her talk, it's like, oh, my God. I mean, could I really put up with that? And what happens when she gets old? Could you stare at that?
Ugh.
I mean, they're really out there, man.
Hey, Giselle, how are you doing?
I'm very good. How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
My girlfriend thinks you're totally hot.
Oh, thank you so much. I'll be jealous if I were you. I'll be like, listen, you gotta just think men are hot. No, that's better if you think that's women, that they have no competition, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
You're the only man, good.
Oh.
Wow. What the hell is she talking about?
My penis would be hypnotized if I saw her in person.
She's stunning.
She's stunning. She's like the most beautiful woman, but my own. I mean, after you do it to her 900 times, could you take that?
What do Aaron DiCaprio possibly talk about?
Nothing. I bet you he makes her be completely silent.
Yeah, good for him.
That's what he talks about.
Only time you
is heart being so beautiful.
I don't find myself that beautiful. I mean, I have met in this business. I've been here for 10 years. As far as beautiful, I found a lot of women a lot more attractive than I am. I just find, you know, beautiful is taste. You know, you can, like, I can judge. I can think red is beautiful and you can think red is hard.
Like, I know coming to a country where this isn't your first language is tough, but, like, if that was my scene, like, let's say they put me in the middle of somewhere, I would just talk very little. Like, I wouldn't talk a lot.
She's willing to talk.
Yeah. She should shut up.
She's got a lot to say.
Horrible, you know, it's about taste. So I really like try to accept if people don't really like me or they think like I'm not that beautiful, think I am. It's like it's all about taste, and everyone should be allowed to, you know, have the taste they want. So.
Why do you think modeling is such a high pressure job?
I don't really see it as a high pressure job. I see it as a job that needs a lot of dedication and a lot of professionalism, which any job needs if you want to do a good job.
Oh man, imagine you're in bed and you just knocked off the greatest piece of ass in the world. And then she starts talking.
You know, I could think red is beautiful.
I don't think I'm beautiful. I'm any more beautiful. Blah, 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 blah.
I think red is beautiful. I think there's a lot of work.
Oh.
can see it as a job, which is, you know, it's a bit more, you know, crazy than other jobs, because you're like 4 days here, 4 days there, so it's harder to have like a relationship, or harder to like build your family. But you know, it's a pretty lucky job, I think.
Are those 36 C's?
No.
How big is Leonardo DiCaprio's penis?
Oh, God. Get out of here.
What?
We need to take a walk, okay? We're down the stairs here, bro.
Yeah?
Okay?
Yeah. No problem.
Finally shut her up.
I love when the interview goes horribly wrong.
But it was great. You know, she had so much to say, and then he said, are those 36 C's? No.
How big is Leonardo DiCaprio, yeah. Carpio's penis? Who's Leonardo DiCaprio?
I don't know.
You got nervous, man.
I don't know this Leonardo DiCaprio.
How big is Leonardo DiCaprio's penis? What'd she say? You crazy.
He did. He blew it at the very end.
And she goes,
get out of here.
Get out of here. Oh. You crazy. Boy, well, he did shut her up, though, didn't he?
Get out of here.
Yep. All of a sudden, she stopped.
Get out of here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's great. I love that crap.
I'm crazy.
Hey, Jay, you're on the air. What's going on? Hey, Jay, you're on the air.
Howard, how you doing?
Hey, brother.
Hey, I'm on my way to work right now, and, you know, you get a coffee in the morning for me.
Thank you.
Me up.
Thank you.
But I'm thinking about taking off of work today and heading over to Union Square, you know, just for a couple hours. I'm wondering, you know, is it going to be worth my while?
Well, it depends what your expectation is. I'm just going to be strolling around and giving out free stuff.
Right. I'm saying, you know, how much free stuff are you going to have?
I got a lot. I got like about 20,000.
20,000.
Right. Free things.
Yeah, that sounds good. You know, it might take an extended lunch hour today. So.
All right.
Take care.
All right, I'll see you over there. Yeah.
All right, man.
You going to come over, Robin?
Uh-huh.
Oh, good.
It's going to be a party.
Yeah. I guess so. I guess it seems to be turning into that.
And then it's clear my schedule.
Yeah. Are you going to be wasted, Artie?
Yeah. You know what? It's Thursday. It's late enough in the week, I think.
He's got the Jack Mayhofer.
He's got the Jack Mayhofer.
A lot of good bars around there.
Jack Mayhofer. Jack Mayhofer.
All right, let's get back to Gary Garver, and then I got to do some FMs. Then he ran into Heidi Klum. The German
Klum.
Heidi Klum.
And Leonardo DiCaprio.
We just had a baby. And she goes out with that guy Seal.
Seal, yes. She didn't have Seal's baby, though.
I gotta tell you, that took me by surprise.
Yeah.
Heidi Klum and Seal.
Yeah, those pictures are startling.
Why?
No, not a real Seal. Just the singer Seal.
Oh, I thought she was dating a real Seal.
That would be startling.
I didn't picture her to go black.
Just because she's German?
Yeah, German, white, you know, white with that blonde hair.
Aryan.
Yeah, that is.
Seal isn't just going black. That's real.
That's like, going back to Africa. What do you say?
That's old school.
That's a black guy.
That's old school black guy. He didn't have any of that white man mixed in with
him. Yeah, if your parents see you two from a distance, they're going to know it's black.
Here's Heidi Klum.
How you doing, Heidi?
Good. How are you doing? Hi.
Why is modeling such a difficult job?
Why is modeling such a difficult job? I don't know. Who says it is so difficult? I have fun with it, so, you know, for me it is not really that difficult. I enjoy it.
Who is your modeling role model?
Don't really have a role model. No.
Role model.
Is it true that you keep your pulled or lost teeth in a pouch?
I do, yes.
Why do you do that?
I don't know. It's kind of like a spell I put on myself a long time ago.
Boy, when you can't see these chicks, it's a drag.
She's got her old teeth in a pouch?
Yeah, how weird is that? It's her good luck thing.
So, and it's kind of like my good luck charm, so everywhere when I fly, I have this little pouch with my teeth in there. Don't ask me why. It's a silly thing, and now I cannot go anywhere without...
Why don't you put your pubes in there, too?
Not them anymore.
I heard that you yodel.
I do.
Can you yodel for me?
No.
Wait, what? Just do it.
Oh, come on.
No, because I've yodeled so many times that I don't really...
I'll do it again, stupid.
You didn't do it for us.
Yeah, do it now.
I don't want to yodel anymore. My yodeling days are over.
Can you bark like a dog?
No.
Uh-oh.
Can you? Why would I? Are you crazy?
Huh?
Keep the question.
And do you prefer black guys or white guys?
Uh-oh.
Sorry?
You prefer black guys or white guys?
You're a very strange man. You know that?
I am?
Yes, you are.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate
Bye.
It.
Okay, let's bring her. You're a very strange man. No, I don't keep my teeth in a pouch.
Right, yeah. Sorry.
You're the strange one.
Yeah.
She probably is right, though. Everything on her was lucky. She got those looks.
Who's this other model? Adriana who? Lima?
Yeah.
Who is she?
Oh, she's hot, man.
Is she? You know her?
I know her face, yeah, from the paper and stuff.
I think Gary gave her a quiz.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. How you doing?
Nice to meet you. I'm good. Thank you.
Is it hard being so beautiful?
Well, I don't think so. I think I was very blessed.
Yeah.
Who is your modeling role model?
I'm sorry?
Who is your modeling role model?
Baba Booey.
Oh.
My inspiration, really, I think, will be a pinup model that her name was Betty Page. And then the second inspiration for me is Marilyn Monroe.
That's cool. At least she had an answer. What kind of questions did he hear? Basics?
Very basic.
Okay. Is she super hot, Artie?
Yeah, she. You know what? She's unreal. Like, so, she's a page stopper. Like when you're flipping through the paper, you go like, whoa.
Dark hair?
Brownish. Like, yeah, brown.
Who is the current VP of the United States?
She ain't gonna know that.
No way.
These chicks don't pay attention. Who's the VP? I don't even sure they know what VP stands for.
What is a VP?
Vice President.
Who is the current?
Who's the current Vice President of the United States?
I don't know.
So you know these chicks.
I don't know.
And you know what? Who cares?
First of all, I mean, are there any models from America anymore?
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's got an accent.
Yeah. And how annoying is it?
You should keep going at it. It's only five questions.
What's the capital of New York?
Oh, she don't know that.
No way.
Why would she?
You think she knows that?
No.
New York.
Boing.
Love it.
How many U.S. states are there?
She's got enough. You think
Nah.
She
doesn't know this.
Howard, she works in the United States fairly often.
You want to go 20 bucks?
She doesn't have to go to all 50.
All right. I say she doesn't know.
I'll say she knows.
I have no idea.
See? This girl, I think, is going to be a slam dunk. She's not going to know anything.
Let's see.
What's the square root of 9?
All right, I say she doesn't know.
No, she knows this.
How much?
20 bucks.
1,000.
Oh, get out.
Wait, so
no way she knows.
Wait, so I owe
she
you,
knows this.
I owe you 20.
All right,
right
20.
Yeah. I owe you 20 now?
Go ahead.
You say she doesn't know it.
Right.
All right, I'll go double nothing. She knows it.
I say she knows it. What?
Square root of 9.
These are mathematic lessons, you know? You tell me the answer.
Oh, 3.
Come on.
3.
Oh, my God.
Wait a minute. Wait
Told
a minute.
You.
Gary Garver got carried away.
She didn't
Well, she
know,
doesn't know.
She didn't know. She didn't know the mathematic answer.
The mathematic answer.
Mathematics?
Who was John Kerry's running mate?
She don't know that.
All right. I owe you $20.
You owe me $1,000. I said $1,000.
Who's, I don't know, what is this question? I'm having like political, I came here to talk about the Victoria's Secret, I think.
Geography and mathematics.
How about you take your clothes
mathematics
off?
Mathematics and geography.
And I put my head in your lap.
She doesn't want to talk about geography.
Geography.
Yeah. Adriana, at the same time, just tell us what you know.
Wow, look at her. She's got pictures of her.
Oh, yeah.
How
hot
is she? She's gorgeous, right? All the Victoria's Secret girls.
Look
at
her
top
ass.
Of the line.
Really give it to her. Very, very hard. It'd be very difficult for her to handle.
Let me see.
The young girl would probably have a difficult time handling my manliness.
Yeah, yeah.
My is. Stench.
Something else.
All right, here is Gary Garver at Night of 1,000 Stars.
Oh, I love it when he goes there every year.
And what's funny about Night of 1,000 Stars, or 100 Stars, excuse me, is that barely anybody there is a TiVo. I got to become a fan. I'm going to work my way into that whole George Lopez world. It's Gary Garver at Night of 1,000 Stars.
Oh, I love it when he goes there every year.
And what's funny about Night of 1,000 Stars, or 100 Stars, excuse me, is that barely anybody there is a star. You know? Night of 100
yeah,
Stars.
Yeah, it's hard to find 100 stars.
Yeah, Night of 100 Stars is really the Oscars.
Here's Gary Garver interviewing. And the pickings were slim, but... But anyway, here's a guy who was a big star. Larry Hagman from Dallas.
Ooh.
Remember J.R. Ewing?
Sure.
All right, here you go.
It's a little bit beyond his day, isn't it?
So what? At least we got somebody famous.
Mr. Hagman, can I ask a couple questions?
Yeah.
Do you consider yourself a good role model? I love
you. Me and Larry Hagman? Hell yes.
Yeah? Why?
Well, I have two children. They're grown up, and I have 5 granddaughters, and I'm nice to them all, and... They're well taken care of and educated, and sure, I'm a nice guy.
Do you support Bush's notion that gay marriage is wrong?
I don't support anything about Bush.
You don't like Bush at all?
No.
If you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
Well, at 73, I don't think they're going to draft me. I was drafted,
you never know,
once, and instead of drafting, I joined the American Air Force for 4 years instead of two.
Have you ever had a gay experience?
A gay experience? I think when I was about 12, a guy made some moves on me, yeah.
What happened?
I avoided it and talked it over with my mother and so forth, and she kind of put me straight on what the world was like out there.
Hey, have you ever slept with a black person?
No, I never have. Have you?
Yeah, I have.
How is it?
It's all right.
Yeah, there you go.
All right. Cool. Hey, is Paris Hilton as idiotic as everyone thinks she is?
Who?
Paris Hilton, she is idiotic as everyone thinks she is.
I don't know her. I've never met the girl.
Who in Hollywood would you most like to have sex with?
Selma Hayek.
Selma Hayek?
Yeah.
Selma Hayek.
Whatever.
She's so beautiful. I guess that's her sister.
I like Larry Hagman. He's cool.
He's hanging in there, isn't he?
So, yeah. Selma Hayek. But that's cool. I mean, you've got an answer. Why, yeah, everyone else is so threatened.
Right.
She's a piece of ass, isn't she?
I don't know, but she's sure beautiful.
And what do you think of Howard Stern?
Howard Stern, I don't listen to him much. He's coming on Sirius Radio, though, and I'll probably hear more about him then.
Will you buy a Sirius Radio, satellite radio? Will you get satellite radio to listen to him?
I do. I have three of them.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, in two cars and in my home.
So you'll tune him in?
Yeah, sure. Try him out.
Hey, thanks a lot, Mr. Hagman.
Sure.
Oh, look at old Larry.
I'm liking this guy. I like old Larry.
He seems like a guy who's happy to be alive, you know.
Well, yeah, he had a transplant, didn't he?
Right.
Yeah, like a liver transplant.
I love hearing stories when those guys survive those liver transplants.
Yeah. I like Papa John Phillips got a liver transplant. They went out drinking. And they followed him with TV cameras.
I love that. I had to test it. It was the liver of a woman who had never drank.
It was like caught on tape. Papa John Phillips. They got him in a bar having like Mai Tais. And
in the middle of the afternoon.
And they pulled him out, and then they were following with the camera. But
he was drinking Long Island iced teas, and I remember that because it's pure alcohol.
He had a new liver.
But he had a brand new liver, and it turned out it was from a black woman who was a church-going woman.
In Atlanta or something.
Yeah, a teetotaler. The liver never had any alcohol.
And apparently didn't like it too much. Yeah. Papa John's not with us anymore.
No, but he had a couple of good years of drinking.
Is that what happened? Did that liver give out?
I don't know. I just know he's gone.
He's gone. He died.
I think he had a heart attack.
Yeah. He was a good soul, though. You know, maybe a little confused, but a good soul.
Well, somewhere in there was a good soul.
All right. Then he ran into Gary Busey. It was always an interesting interview. I haven't heard
any. Was that 100 stars?
Yeah. I haven't heard any of these, by the way.
Gary.
Hey.
Okay. Gary, how you doing?
Good, very good.
Do you consider yourself a good role model?
With?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Who?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Okay.
Do you consider yourself a good role model?
I'm not really the one to judge that. I know in the way I'm living now and what I've discovered through the journey of my life, yes, I am going to be, and I am a good role model.
Were you before, or did this come about?
I love this guy.
Oh, yeah.
He's the best interview ever. He always sounds like he's wasted.
I think there's a reason for that.
It just sounds, hey, I'm hearing those voices again in my head.
Me too.
Now, do you two suffer the same psychosis?
No. We work for the same radio station.
These voices are saying, kill a dog.
Every time we hear that, what is it?
I don't know. It's pretty prominent right now.
No, hold on. Yeah, you just...
What happened? You did something.
No, I hear it.
There.
What is that, Fred?
You know, it can't be. I thought it might have been the headphones because, like, the guy runs commercials in the other room, but it's not that. So it's.
I thought we isolated the problem already.
It's always something new.
Oh, I got it. Listen to this.
What is it?
I don't know. Somebody shut it off. I don't know how.
What happened?
Hey, whoever's doing that, can you stop it? You must know what you're doing.
I was always growing into that mold.
Hey, if you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
What?
If you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
Well, that's a stupid question because there is no draft.
Do you remember what song was playing when you lost your virginity?
Do I remember what kind of pain I caused when I lost my virginity?
Song was playing.
What?
You support gay marriage?
What's this about, man? What are you doing here?
What? I'm asking questions.
This is your show. This is not political canvassing.
Just asking. What, do you support gay marriage?
It doesn't matter. No, it doesn't matter if I support it or not.
Have you ever slept with a black person?
Goodbye. Good luck on your
name. Hey, let me ask you one more.
Hi. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to interrupt you guys. Okay.
No, these questions are wrong.
What? Hey, what do you think of Howard Stern?
Those four questions have no respect in them.
They don't have any respect? They're just bad questions.
Sure. They're stupid questions.
What do you think about Howard Stern, what the government's doing to him?
Go ahead.
You look very handsome tonight. May I just say?
Give me a hug.
Give me a hug?
Did he just ask that woman for a hug?
Yeah.
That's got no respect. Give me a hug.
What's James Cromwell? I don't even know who that is.
He's an actor, and he's on 6 Feet Under, and he was in the pig movies, babe.
Great. Mr. Cromwell, how you doing?
Fine, thank you, man. Good, thank you.
What's the most exciting thing about Oscar night?
Getting free food, seeing your friends, and going home. Watching the show, enjoying the laughs, and not having to worry about sweating it out about whether you're going to make one or not.
Does it bother you that these big Hollywood events are taking place while our soldiers are being killed in a senseless war?
It certainly does. And now that's a very sensitive question. In actual fact, this whole celebration is obscene, given the circumstances. And I can understand how the rest of the people in the world going through this, especially people in the Middle East, would say, what is the matter with those people? It's unfortunate that this has been made into such a zoo. It's basically a community of actors and a community of directors and people in this industry acknowledging people's excellence to have it blown into celebrity and ratings and money is slightly obscene.
Wow, that guy's cool.
Why is he there? He's a major activist. Very political.
I dig him.
But he's out there.
Yeah. And I work.
He's participating in it.
I worked with him.
Someone told me he's the guy in the Star Trek movie who discovered warp speed.
Yes, that's right. He did that too.
He's also Stretch Cunningham from All in the Family.
He is. That's right.
Is he really?
Yeah.
I worked with this guy in a movie. I worked with him for about a month. And he's a real political guy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And interesting.
Here's some things I found out about him, Howard. He was once arrested in Virginia. Him and a bunch of people from PETA went to Wendy's, and they just wouldn't leave, so they got arrested. And he's been in a bunch of Star Trek movies.
That ain't cool, though. You can't go to Wendy's and bum people out about their food. If somebody wants to eat steak, let them.
Well, he feels that's wrong.
And big-time vegan.
Yeah.
But he's the kind of vegan where you look at him, he looks like he could use a roast beef sandwich. He looks like he's getting a little...
It says here he's a believer in non-terrestrial intelligence.
Yeah.
Non-terrestrial intelligence. What's that?
I don't know.
That would be alien intelligence.
No.
What? No.
Non-terrestrial intelligence.
Right.
That means not of this earth.
Extraterrestrial is not of this earth.
Well, non-terrestrial would also be not of this earth.
Huh.
I have something to say about that.
Non-Earth. He's into non-Earth.
Non-Earth intelligence.
And maybe he really is the guy who developed warp speed.
And he was in Star Trek. He did a bunch of Star Trek
stuff. That's what I just said.
Yeah.
He's the guy who developed warp speed.
Yeah, he was in one of the best Star Trek movies ever.
Okay. What is the name of the guy, the doctor, who developed warp speed?
Well, I have it here.
Oh, don't you say it then.
Oh, God.
If you remember this, this is good. Then you're
not that big a
geek. If you know this, you're
a turd. Yeah.
I could think about this for 42 years. I wouldn't have a guess.
Ralph should be calling up right now.
Fred, do you know?
I knew he was in that movie, but I don't know.
I think it's Thaddeus.
I know they used to refer to him all the time.
Wait, am I right about the first name, Thaddeus?
They're saying that this is a Star Trek character. They give a name. Is that
Phineas?
That? No.
What?
Zefram?
Yeah. No, right. Zefram Cochrane.
Zefram Cochrane. That's right.
Does warp speed.
He's the only character to be mentioned in all 5 Star Trek series, and he was the only guy that actually used the word Star Trek in a Star Trek movie.
Why?
It just said that you're all astronauts of some kind of Star Trek. I don't know. They have all these Star Trek facts here about him. He's also the tallest Oscar-nominated actor ever.
How tall is he?
6'7".
Do you support gay marriage?
I certainly do. I think gay people should have all the rights of any other citizen. They're citizens. They shouldn't be deprived. Whatever they want to call it, that's fine with me.
Michael Jackson, guilty or innocent?
Oh, I have no idea, mate. That's why we have courts of law.
Hey, do you remember what song was playing when you lost your virginity?
I wasn't listening to the...
No.
Have you ever slept with a black person?
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
I answered all the questions.
You know, if I remember correctly, he told me that he used to work with the Black Panther Party in the early 70s.
I wouldn't doubt it. He is radical.
Yeah. Yeah, he probably got a lot of black poontang.
Yeah, that's cool.
Radical.
He's also great in the movie L.A. Confidential.
Yeah, he's the bad guy.
Baby.
All right.
He's done a lot of stuff.
Zephyrin Cochran. I got some other people here, too. George Lopez. I don't know him.
He's on that, he has his own TV show.
Howard, that's just 50 seconds of George Lopez kissing your ass.
Yeah.
Ooh, let's hear that.
Well, maybe I'm a new fan. What do you think of Howard Stern?
I think he's great, yeah.
What,
all the time.
What do you think about what the...
You know what, I think when he gets to serious radio is when radio will really take off. I mean, and I think it's like a rocket that's going to blast off and leave part of its tail behind. I mean, FM has never been a place for creative people. And to me, Howard Stern is like no other guy who's ever been on the...
Wow, look at this guy.
Who knew?
What show is he on?
He's on the George Lopez show.
George Lopez show.
I'm going to start watching this thing. I'm watching this guy.
Radio, and there's a lot of morning guys and Billy and Bob's and all kinds of guys like that, but no one even comes close. Mancow or whoever's out there, no one comes close to what the guy does day in and day out. And, you know, I'm not a serious radio holder right now, but when he goes, I will become.
Thanks a lot, George.
All right, dude.
He's one of that one in five.
He must have missed that survey. Hey, I like this guy, George Lopez. That's my guy.
He's a good guy.
Is he stand-up?
He's a stand-up
comedian. He was a stand-up, and now he has a huge TV show's a hit.
The business he does at clubs is unmatched. He's
very funny
and
very filthy.
Yeah.
Is he filthy? I like that.
Right. He loves you. I met him at Hollywood Squares once. I mean, he loves you.
Yeah.
And, he got his show because Sandra Bullock saw him. She's the one who got him on TV.
Wow. Wow. Well, that's a cool dude. Says some nice things. You know, you don't hear too many people saying that kind of stuff. All you hear is like, you know, I'm a scumbag.
Well, not successful people, anyway. Usually it's Larry Flint.
Yeah. Hey, usually Larry Flint's defending me, which is fine, but...
Yeah, but you need help from other quarters.
And George Lopez, thanks, man. Give you a shout-out. And I hope you get your American citizenship, man.
The show's on ABC for the rest.
All right, I'm going to watch it. I mean it. I'm going to TiVo. I got to become a fan. I'm going to work my way into that whole George Lopez world. Why not? Was that chick here yet?
Yes, she's here.
Oh, she's so good looking.
Is she here?
Yeah. What's she wearing?
Is it just...
I don't know. I looked at her, but I don't know what she's wearing.
Didn't she get naked in here the last time?
I think she like got naked and did things to herself last time, which was amazing.
I put a picture of Heidi on howardstern.com so people could see her. Check her out. She's really hot. All right, we got to take a break. We'll be back right after these words.
This is the Howard Stern Show.
Gary Garver went and interviewed Carol Burnett, Tommy Smothers, and Jason Priestley at TV Land Awards. I don't know if anybody cares about that.
Those are former TV stars?
Yeah, the TV Land Award Show. Now, that's hitting rock bottom.
That's
Why would anyone show up at that?
It's great that Jason Priestley's the only one there under 60.
I think they probably pay people to show up, right?
I guess.
It can't be for real. Gary Garver with Carol Burnett, who used to be a real big star. Let's see what she's got to say.
Hi. How are you?
Good.
I'm a big fan of yours.
Thank you. Hi.
How's it feel to be the legend tonight?
I don't know. I think it's wonderful. It's a terrific honor for our show. And, plus, you get a free meal. I mean, what's to complain about?
Hey, if there's one thing you could change about your life, what would it be?
Nothing.
Yeah. Have you ever had a gay experience?
A what?
A gay experience. Have you ever had one?
What do you mean?
Like, homosexual experience?
No, but I've had gay experiences. But see, gay to me means happy.
Did you ever work with Robert Blake?
No.
What do you think about him?
I have no comment.
And have you ever slept with a black person?
Hey, Carol. The era of the bride.
Not that I think there's anything wrong with that. I just never came up.
Carol, but in the era of the bride.
All right. That's pretty good.
I would have thought she would have slept with a black
guy. Yeah. I could see her going with a black guy.
Yeah, something big liberal.
Yeah. Yeah, what's the matter?
Are you racist or something?
Yeah. You want to hear Gary Garver with Tommy Smothers?
Yeah, that sounds funny.
No, it doesn't.
Actually,
I don't know if I care.
Gary with older time stars seems to be a good combination.
Which one was Tommy Smothers?
He was the blonde guy.
Oh, the blonde
right, okay.
Guy.
Well, the one without the mustache, right? Yeah. The one whose son isn't a porno star.
Right.
Tommy, how you doing? How's it going?
Good.
What's your reaction to Howard Stern's upcoming move to satellite radio?
About Howard Stern?
Yeah.
I always found that Howard Stern, what a strange situation in this country when Howard Stern has become a poster boy for the First Amendment. I mean, when there's so many things that should be said, and what we're focusing on in this country is the number of four-letter words or the sexual implications when the world's falling apart. No real discussions being made there.
Hey, which sexual act is your favorite to perform?
Suzanne, Tom? Favorite what?
What sexual act is your favorite to perform?
Oh, this is for Howard Stern. Yeah, sweeping.
Do you think Michael Jackson should seek rehabilitation?
I think Michael Jackson's fine. I think he's being... That kind of stuff happens. People try, I think, half those priests, all those people that are hundreds of people, they're just jumping in, making up stuff. See, I'd like some of that money, too. I think it's extortion. That's what it is.
You think they're extorting him?
Yeah, sure I do. I think he's strange, but that has nothing to do with it.
And have you ever slept with a black person?
Yeah.
How was it?
Fine. And Chinese people, too.
Really?
The Japanese person was nice. Yeah, very nice.
What's better, Chinese, Japanese, or black?
Women are fine. You know, they're all fine.
Thanks a lot, Tom.
You're welcome.
Honest guy, I like him. Maybe no one cares, but I did. I liked it. And he had nice things, I think, to say about me.
Right. It was weird the way he put it, but...
I think he was saying, who cares about Howard Stern doing that stuff?
Right. Let you be.
Yeah. Do you even care about Jason Priestley anymore?
I care more about Tommy's mother.
Yeah, all right.
The only thing with Jason is he says he's never been mad at you.
Oh, all right. So that's good. Who cares?
But I don't believe him.
I don't even spend a minute thinking about it, whether he's mad at me or not. Who would care if he's mad at me? That's insanity. All right, let me see what I got here. I got a million tapes. I got a million games we could play. I got a whole bunch of people on hold on phones. Let me just say, this is kind of dumb. You remember that guy, Stephen Bishop? He did that song, On and On. You know this song? You know this song.
Of course I know.
From the 80s.
I'm just listening.
Down in Jamaica, they got lots of pretty women. Steal your money, then they break your heart.
Gary Garver went somewhere in Los Angeles and ran into Stephen Bishop and interviewed him.
He's still around.
Yeah, he was at the ASCAP Awards.
Why?
I don't know, but do you want to hear it? Or do you
all
want
right.
Me, all right.
That's it with Stephen Bishop.
I mean, do you have one of Gary Garver interviewing my uncle? Because I'm just as interested.
I know. The guy said Gary Garver interviewed Stephen Bishop. I go, isn't that the guy who turned to Jesus? And I go, that's Stephen Baldwin.
Right.
But with Stephen Bishop.
Actually, the first thing you said to me, you go, oh, the guy that sang Fooled Around and Fell in Love, and I go, that was Elvin Bishop.
The first person I thought, the comedian from the Rat Pack, and that's Joey Bishop.
Right.
Fooled around and fell in love.
That's him, too?
No.
Nope, that's Elvin.
Oh, that's Elvin.
Anyway, here's Stephen Bishop, for those of you who care.
How you doing?
Yeah. Hey, how you doing?
How you doing, Stephen?
Great. How are you? Good.
Hey, do you think it was wrong that Paula Abdul had sex with an American Idol contestant?
Well, You're going right ahead and saying that she did. Do I think it's wrong? That's kind of like, when did you stop beating your wife kind of question. Do I think it was wrong? That's a good question. If it were true,
wow, that's a hard
question. You know, since I know Paula, I mean, I know Paula in the past, and she's really a sweet person, and I'm not sure how to approach that question right now.
Obviously.
Hey, how old were you when you lost your virginity?
Oh, these are weird questions. What station is this?
Indie Broadcasting.
Oh, right, right, okay. How old were I was 18, actually. Actually, I've never been asked that question, but I guess it's pretty important when it comes down to it, at the time especially. I was 18. I was dying to lose my virginity. I think every guy is just wants to get rid of it. It's like a curse when you're a teen, you know, and you just want to hurry up and get on with it, you know.
Hey, what part of your body are you most self-conscious of?
Oh, Jesus Christ. It's weird. What part of my body am I most self-conscious of? I don't know. My wrists, because I don't have, like, big manly wrists. I wish I had, like, that manly wrist look.
Hey, what do you think of Pat O'Brien's infamous voicemails?
I think that special was really one of the tackiest things I've ever seen. I didn't watch much of it. I watched like 5 minutes of it. I thought the whole thing was tacky. And I really like Dr. Phil. I think he's great, but I think that's the worst thing he's ever done. I think that whole thing was so. It's like there's a point when you've got to just, you know, have some kind of privacy with your life, and you can't just tell everybody what's going on. And you know, with
this isn't bad for his first
Wait
interview.
A minute,
this
no.
is his first interview since 1988. I mean,
he must be lonely.
Yeah,
everything, and I mean, everybody needs something.
We're going to check back with Stephen Bishop in 2022 while we're doing a radio
He's
show.
He's like one of those old people you call to sell something on the phone. They just want to talk.
Some amount of privacy to their lives, you know, and it's just, I just thought that's nobody's business. He should have just done his. You know, he goofed up and he messed up and, you know, let him deal with it. You know, I don't know. I didn't dig that.
Hey, do you think Gary Bababooey Delabate has gotten fat?
Gary Delabate?
Yeah.
What, is he a baseball player?
No, he's a producer.
A producer for what?
Howard Stern Show.
Gary Bababooey. Oh, Bababooey. Oh, Bababooey. Yeah, I know him by that name. You know, I've been watching Howard Stern as much lately because I got TiVo and I've been watching so much TiVo. But I was going to start putting Howard Stern on the TiVo. Last time I saw him, he looked pretty dapper.
Hey, are you scared of black people?
Oh, yeah, actually, no. No, I'm not.
Do you drink the protein shake?
Do I drink a protein shake?
Do you drink the protein shake?
What's the protein shake?
I don't know.
No, I don't drink any protein shake. All
right, thanks a lot, Steve.
All right, thanks. All right.
And it's just oddly compelling.
Wow.
The Stephen Bishop interview that you've been waiting for.
On and On should have been written about his interviews.
Lonesome Sue, she's in love with old Sam. Taken from the fire.
There he is.
Frying pan on and on. She just keeps on trying.
On and On.
Oh, that's what I always thought it was going to be.
Could he have made enough money from On and On to live the rest of his life?
Seems like he's living on it.
Yeah.
On and On.
I had two best-selling books, and I can't live on that. How do these guys hang around?
Because their songs still get played, and they get residuals.
Oh, no wonder he's at the ASCAP Awards. All right, real quick. Gary Garver went down to the porn party, L.A. porn party. I don't know.
What's
just
that?
Just a bunch of porn stars hanging around. Probably they sign stuff for horny guys and they get paid.
I was going to say, isn't that every day when you're a porn star? It's a party?
Oh, I don't think so. I think there's a lot of downtime that's pretty scary. I'm pretty sure of that. There's a lot of low self-esteem moments. Here's
a lot of crying after you finish working.
Here's a couple of them. Marie Love. I don't know her, but have we had her on the show?
No, I think Marie Love's a black woman, I believe.
Okay. I don't even know what he asked. We're hearing these for the first time.
What's your name?
Marie Love.
Do you ever have sex with a retard for free?
No.
Why?
Wait, what kind of retard, though?
Like a mental retard.
No, because I was walking by a retard in school, and one of them went off and hit me in my back for nothing. So, no, thank you. Yeah.
What's the strangest object you used in a sexual manner?
A Tootsie Roll Pop. I was with it, so I'm and
really?
Yeah. And it was crazy because I didn't shave back then.
It was crazy.
Thank you.
Nothing better than a hairy Tootsie Pop.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. Interesting line of questioning.
They'll answer anything, these stars.
That's why I like porn stars. They don't have airs about them.
Well, this next one has no airs.
I'd rather not discuss that.
This next
Who's
one
has, Missy Monroe?
I don't know, but she's up for anything.
What's your name?
Missy Monroe.
Would you have sex with my dog for $5,000?
Your dog, no.
No?
No, I have a dog.
How about a retard for free? Would you do have sex with him?
I probably wouldn't have sex with him, but he could on my face.
Really?
Yeah. Nice.
Hey, guys.
Well, the first...
I like these girls. They don't rant about psychiatry and Ritalin. They admit they're porn stars and they're up for fun.
One which I won an award for, it was on Baker's Dozen. I 41 guys and then they all on my face, and then two girls ate it off, and the second one was 52 guys.
52
guys?
Yeah.
What happened?
I don't know. There's so many bleeps. I don't know what happened.
Goodness.
At once, or they take turns?
They took turns, but I'm sure maybe one or two may have been retarded.
Probably, huh?
Probably.
Out of 50 guys, probably one or two were retarded, huh?
Yeah, or had a little bit of mental issues or something.
All right. Some searing interviews from Gary Garber. Very honest interviews.
He's off book. I think he's coming up with these on his own.
Yeah. He's the Barbara Walters of porn interviews.
All you hear is they all, a long bleep, and then my face.
Yeah, and it sounds bad.
I'm telling you, I was like, wait a minute, that's illegal.
They all blanked on my face.
And then two girls blanked.
It off.
53 bleep. With this girl, Howard.
Sunny Lane,
we thought this was interesting because we always wonder how girls get into porn, what the path is.
What's your name?
Sunny Lane.
Now, how long have you been in the business, Sunny?
5 months.
Tell me what you'd like to accomplish with your life after your porn career is over.
Hopefully I'll own a lot of houses and I'll own a skating rink one day. I'm a former professional ice skater.
Oh, you are?
That's what I was doing before this. Yeah.
A professional ice skater? Did you, like, win anything?
Yeah, I'm regional national champion. I had bunion surgery, and I was getting ready to go to the 2006 Olympics for ice dancing, and so I got hurt, and needless to say, it's hard to stand on the side of the board to coach those little kids and not being able to skate and compete for myself, so I had to make a new career, and here I am.
You're from the ice skater to a porn star.
I wonder if her grandpa ever played horsey with her. Your dad never played horsey with you, did he?
No.
Yeah. He didn't even play a fun game.
No, we never even had any games.
Yeah. I didn't like your father.
It was right down to business.
Yeah, really.
Your father angers me. At least a fun game first. Wow. Don't let your kids get bunions. Lean right into porn.
Yeah, you know, right off the ice and into the sack.
Yep. Time to start the news, or do I have to take a break first? Break first, news next, right this.
And now, Howard Stern interviews close friend Frank Gifford.
Edward Johnson, Syracuse Daily Times.
Hello, fellas. First of all, I want to say I'm enjoying this very much.
Thank you.
Also, Frank, I read recently, I don't know if this is quite on topic, that you're a bit of a hero. You discovered a lump in your wife's breast. You care to comment on that?
I really have no comment on that.
Do you still love your wife?
I have no comment on that to you.
Try to keep to the topic of the film that's coming up.
I see. Well, who do you feel has nicer breasts, Kathy Lee or Susan Johnson?
Gil, can we
take him? Taken care of.
Oh, yeah. Good morning, everybody. Stevie Wonder's pretty good, but I think I'm a lot better listening to this song. Got a big show for you today. Gary Garber was with Jay Leno and James Garner.
Where were they?
I don't know. Someplace, but evidently James Garner kick Gary Garber in the balls or hit him with a microphone in the balls. So.
Really? So is Gary suing?
What do you do?
Gary's going to hit Gary in the testicles with his cane.
I think that's a suable offense.
He got Leno and Garner together?
No, two different events.
I said, what, do you go to a lame convention?
But isn't it embarrassing when you go somewhere and an old dude beats you with his cane and the balls?
That sounds absolutely hilarious.
But in all fairness,
I was beaten with an old guy's cane.
Well, I hope he just took the beating because this is an old guy and you can't win by beating him up.
Yeah, don't you think Gary Garver could kick James Garner's ass?
No, I should hope.
And knowing Gary, I think he would try to beat up an old guy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually,
you want to know the truth? I'm pretty sure James Garner could beat me up because I can't fight.
Well, especially now that he's holding a cane.
But, if James Garner hit me in the nuts with a cane, I don't know that I could do anything about it.
You can't.
No, because he's an old dude. What do you do? I mean, you can't. First of all, the guy's got to be, close to 80.
Yes.
If you beat him up, you're a dick. And if he beats you up, you're a jerk.
You describe yourself as a curmudgeon. I think that's fair.
What was that?
I don't know why that started.
And you hit it. That was James Garner.
I must have hit the button by accident. I didn't want to play it at that point.
I had it anyway.
Radio or the TV. Is there something that just drives you nuts?
Talk shows.
Talk shows. Talk
shows. This wasn't too scripted.
What does it drive you nuts? Tell me.
I think more these experts on sports and, whatever. Politics and everything, and they're not any smarter than anybody that reads the paper. Okay. And it really, puts me off.
Anybody in particular, Bob? Is there one that sticks in your craw?
Well, one talk show, I guess you could call it. What's his name? Stern?
Oh, Howard Stern.
Howard Stern.
God damn
it.
Man.
What do you say, God damn him? Or dimwit? Dimwit.
No taste, dimwit. I mean, the man's taste is in his feet.
Really? Yeah, well, don't hold back. I mean, feel free to express yourself.
Okay, I'll really let into him. No, I better not.
Oh, that hurt.
Like he had something else to say.
He has nothing to say.
That was the second time he picked on you, though. The first time he picked on you was because he said he was accidentally tooling around the satellite and he accidentally saw your pay-per-view special.
How do you accidentally see a pay-per-view special? Don't you have to order
it? You have to buy that. They don't just give that to you.
It's like accidentally seeing porno.
Right.
How do you do that?
And I think the one he's referring to was the New Year's Eve one that we did.
Yeah, that was a great special.
Where you,
how dare he?
Where you arrive on stage and sitting on a toilet.
Well, here he is, Gary Garver. I haven't even heard this thing, but it's got to be good. Gary Garver with James Garner. At the
Howard Stern exclusive.
At the what?
I don't even know why he ran into him.
Congratulations on your honor, Mr. Garner. Can I ask you,
By the way, Gary Garver looks like he's got marbles in his mouth. How's this guy?
Gary Garble.
Yeah, Gary Garble. Rename him Gary Garble. Yeah. And how does this guy get work in broadcasting?
I mean, the only ones who'll hire him.
Yeah, I don't think it's actually work in broadcasting.
Excuse me, Mr. Garble.
It's funny, I've been editing Gary's stuff for years.
Yeah.
And quite often, the celebrities ask Gary to repeat the question.
And he doesn't have any kind of a speech impediment.
No.
Excuse me, I want to go into broadcasting.
And it sucks, because then he's got to repeat this insanely awkward question.
When you were at Connecticut School of Broadcasting, were 99% of the dudes like Gary Garver?
They were all like me, like losers who were just an inch away from prison.
Yeah, it's like,
I want to go into broadcasting.
Yeah, I mean, no one there was a future.
Artie says it's pre-prison.
Well, Artie
had a choice, go to prison or go to Connecticut School of Broadcasting.
Artie was court-ordered to go there.
Well,
oh, that's too funny.
My probation officer said you should get an activity.
Besides gambling and drinking and doing coke.
Right, so he said, do something. So that's what I did.
Mr. America was drinking pretty heavily Saturday night.
I'm
one to talk.
I was dying to know what his strategy was.
Well,
he was doing.
I saw him at the beginning. Well, I'll tell you all about Saturday.
Okay.
And we taped the whole thing. It's going to air somewhere else. Kevin, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Howard. How you doing?
Hi, brother.
Hey, I just wanted to let you know that Jay Leno clip you were playing yesterday morning.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was in the kitchen making breakfast. My radio was in the bedroom, and my 65-pound pit bull started flipping out, ran right up through the glass door. Through the glass.
Drove him crazy, huh?
Yeah, he just.
Hey, Gary, do you have the Jay Leno interview? I played that early in the morning.
You know what? I think it's rank funny, Howard.
Really? Oh, Gary Garver and, Jay Leno. And this is great stuff.
Yeah, and I'm in Florida. It was during the hurricane, so I got wind and rain blowing through the house.
Thanks.
It was fun.
Yeah, this is pretty interesting. Gary Garver from Los Angeles went out to some event, and Jay Leno was there. And old Jay freaked out, I think. I did learn that we are not going to be... I'm not going to certainly be on The Tonight Show anytime soon.
It doesn't seem so.
No, and that's fine with me.
But that's interesting. You finally got through to Jay.
Yeah, I think he understands I'm for real. That I'm not his friend. No. Howard and I are friends, I'm telling you. No, we're not friends. You're a bore. I have no respect for you. You rip off half the stuff from this show. And my next guest is Kenneth Keith Kallenbach and Stuttering John.
That was awful.
And then when we're done with that, I'm going to go and ask people ordinary questions and see if they can answer them. And I'll call it jaywalking. But no. Howard didn't start that. No.
I'm going to send a goofy guy to the red carpet to cover the Oscars.
Next we'll send somebody goofy to the red carpet.
With silly questions.
Hey, Jay.
Oh, I'll wait. It's okay.
Hey, how'd you come up with jaywalking?
Just like this. What is this for? What are we talking?
It's a Findy broadcast.
What is it?
He knows right away he didn't come up with jaywalking.
Well, that's funny that right away he has to investigate. Who are you? What? Where are you from?
Once people forget about Howard, I'll be able to say I came up with it. I don't know. I was taking a shower and it came to me.
He sounds like James Garner.
Infinity Broadcasting.
Oh, Infinity. Oh, yes. Infinity.
Is there anybody in Hollywood you dislike?
No, I like everybody. I do.
Hey, Howard Stern has openly said he doesn't like you. How do you respond to that?
That's fine. It helps Howard rating. It's fine with me.
Would you have Howard Stern on your show even though he despises you?
Well, probably not. Well, he wouldn't come on, so...
If he would come on, would you have him on?
I think it's a moot point.
Why was Johnny never a guest on your show?
Is that cutting out?
I think we got to get him in there.
What?
Break. I think Thursday.
Thanks.
I think the mic's cutting out.
Okay, thank you.
Why was Johnny Carson not a guest on your show? Let me answer that for you, Jay. He wasn't a guest on your show because he thought you were a scumbag. Okay, and Johnny was the biggest scumbag on the planet. Johnny Carson was the biggest scumbag on the planet.
Until Jay.
He beat his first wife, right? Divorced her, let her live in poverty, married a list of women, had sex with every woman he could have and dumped her. He was mean to all of his people, including Ed McMahon. He was the biggest scumbag in show business, not letting comedians. Some comedians had to not sit on his couch. Some had to sit on his couch. You had to sit there and fight. He would torture comedians. He was a fellow comic, and he would torture comedians. They were the only guests that were evaluated whether they could sit on his couch.
Meanwhile, every musician got a bye.
Love musicians, suck their ass. But comedians he treated like the garbage he was. He was the biggest scumbag on the planet, and he... Johnny thought you were a scumbag. Do you know what that means?
He was afraid of you.
You know what that means for the top scumbag in the world to think you're a scumbag?
It's like Hitler calling you anti-Semitic.
Right. Hitler goes, you know, I hated Jews. I killed 6 million of them. But I'm going to tell you something. This guy, with his attitude towards Jews, it bothers me.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it bothers
me. This guy's nuts.
This guy's nuts. Okay? That's like Hitler saying you're nuts.
Is Stuttering John slowly being phased out of The Tonight Show?
Thursday.
What?
Tonight Thursday.
Here's Jay doing an impression of a microphone cutting out.
That was really bad.
But of a mic and out, it's that way.
Right. He's horrible.
He's horrible at it.
Was incorporating a horn into the bit.
Yeah, he's got all kinds. Is
that supposed to be his beep when he's cursing, I suppose?
I see. Technically.
If you could roast Howard in two sentences, what would you say? Why'd you drop the word stuttering, Stuttering John's name?
Because it's Thursday.
Thursday. But why would he say... his microphone's cutting out, right? Why would he say Thursday? No, Thursday.
Yeah, he doesn't realize you drop part of the word.
Yeah, pretend you're answering. You wouldn't work Thursday into why did you drop stuttering.
Every answer is Thursday.
Right. He's giving the same answer to every question.
What's the worst thing about being you, Jay?
Because they're fine.
What?
They're fine. There's something's cutting out. I'd love to help you. There's some... This is the short. Every time, say what? See, there's some kind of short.
Would you have Howard on your show?
What a good thing.
What?
Look, hey,
baby, hey, hey,
Would you have Howard on your show?
Thursday. This is bizarre.
I love that in Jay's Perfect Life, I'm the only problem.
This is very bizarre.
And by the way, how would Jay know the mic's cutting out? In other words, okay, his premise is the mic is cutting out. He wouldn't know that.
Yeah, let's dissect this.
Yeah, let's dissect. He goes, hey, isn't the mic cutting out Thursday? So how would you know the mic is cutting out?
Yeah.
No one would, because they're not. None of them are wearing headphones.
And why isn't it cutting out when Gary's speaking?
Yeah. If I was going to pretend the mic was cutting out, I would pretend I didn't know. I'd say, yeah, you know, Howard, good.
Right.
I don't like ever again. That's how I would do
it. Yeah. And then you go on. Ask me another question.
No, this is Jay goes, the mic's cutting out.
Beep,
Thursday.
Beep,
beep, beep, Thursday, Thursday.
And we're hearing all of Gary's question, clearly.
Right. The whole thing's weird.
You see, get the mic fixed and come back and talk to me.
Thanks.
Talk to
me. I think we need to hear it again without me interrupting now. Do you agree? Do you agree?
Christ, I don't know. I don't know if I want to hear it again.
I don't. I mean, really, I'm very disturbed.
I say we hear it again without my interruption.
I don't think you can do it without interruption.
Congratulations on your honor, Mr. Gardner. Okay.
All right, that's the other one.
That's a good one.
That's a good one, too.
On your ordinary, Mr. Gardner.
Let's do that first, then I'll play Jay Leno again. This is Gary Garver interviewing James Garner, who evidently hates me. James Garner is like this 9-million-year-old actor who used to be on the Rockford Files and some other shows.
Maverick.
And he hates me for some reason. We've never really ascertained why.
Yeah, I don't know what you did to him.
Yeah, but he claims he was watching pay-per-view New Year's Eve, and he accidentally happened upon my show, which is another fake premise, because you don't accidentally tune into pay-per-view. You have to order it.
What, did he think he was getting porn?
Yeah, I mean, how do you accidentally order my show? He's probably like, you know, I need a hardcore porno. I thought Howard Stern was a porno. And I feel like I got ripped off.
But it takes a lot of effort to order. Yeah. Like, it's like saying I accidentally did Rubik's Cube or something.
Yeah. I got tricked into it. Yeah.
And I solved it.
And Gary Garver, I don't know what, we called him Gary Garble yesterday because the first question we can't even make out.
Congratulations on your honor, Mr. Gardner. I can ask you.
Mr. Gardner.
Yes.
Have you changed the world?
What?
Have you changed the world?
Who?
You. Have you changed?
Me?
Yeah.
Nothing. It changed me, but who do you work for?
Trinity Broadcasting.
Well, who they are.
You've worked with a lot of beautiful women in your lifetime. Who was the hottest woman you ever worked with?
I don't remember. I had about 28.
Okay. Is it true that you helped Martin Luther King Jr. organize his March on Washington?
I didn't help him personally, but yes, I did.
How did you do that, sir?
How did I do that?
Do you find
your phone, people? What is your next list? I want to get all these down because they sound really the dumbest questions I think I've ever heard.
Do you think that you find your penis shrinks with age?
No, but I'll tell you what, yours is, because I'm going to kick you right in the balls. I knew that's who you were.
Do you have a message for Howard Stern?
Back off.
For him? Talk to him in my sleep.
Back off, I said.
Thank you. Don't you ever show up again.
Let him be.
Your cane's going to knock me silly?
That's enough, sir.
I'm going to. You see this?
Yeah. All right. What?
He grabbed Gary Garver. First he took his cane and whacked Gary Garver in the balls.
That's great.
And then he grabbed the microphone and pulled it out. Now, yeah. There's a microphone that doesn't work.
I notice we can't hear anything.
Gary Garver got whacked in the balls by James Garner Kane, which is the worst thing you can have happen. The guy's got to be like 80.
Yeah.
And if he fights back, he looks like a dick.
Yeah, the reason he has a cane is because he's not steady on his feet.
Yeah.
So if you even touch him, he topples over and you look like a brute.
My favorite part is when he goes, "Don't you ever show up again."
Yeah. To what?
Like, who are you? What do you mean, don't you show up again?
Yeah, I mean, he could accidentally be at the same restaurant.
Show up where? Yeah.
In life. And then he calls him an effing a-hole?
Yeah.
Nothing funnier than an old guy. You effing a-hole. You don't want to hear Jay Leno played all the way through?
All right, let me see if I can try it. After a little break, maybe I can take it.
Hey, Jay.
Oh, I'll wait. It's okay.
Hey, how'd you come up with jaywalking?
Just like this. What is this for? What are we talking? What is
Infinity Broadcast.
What is it?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Oh, Infinity. Oh, yes, yes. Infinity.
Hey, is there anybody in Hollywood you dislike?
No, I like everybody. I do all right.
Hey, Howard Stern has openly said he doesn't like you. How do you respond to that?
That's fine. It helps Howard rating. It's fine with me.
Would you have Howard Stern on your show even though he despises you?
Well, probably not. Well, he wouldn't come on, so.
If he would come on, would you have him on?
I think it's a moot point.
Why was Johnny never a guest on your show?
Is that cutting out?
I think we got to get him in there. Thanks.
What? Break. I think Thursday.
Thanks.
I think the mic's cutting out.
Okay, thank you.
Why? Is Stuttering John slowly being phased out of the Tonight Show?
It's on Thursday.
What?
It's on Thursday.
If you could roast Howard in two sentences, what would you say?
Look at that. It's like a fat nine.
Why'd you drop the word Stuttering John's name?
Because it's Thursday.
Thursday.
What's the worst thing about being you, Jay?
It's a thing.
Thursday.
That's right.
Something's cutting out.
How's he know?
I'd love to help you. There's a short every time. Say watch. See, there's some kind of short.
Would you have Howard on your show?
Well, look at that.
What?
Look at that.
You see, get the mic fixed and come back and talk to me.
Thanks.
Talking to
you. It's weird when his microphone is cutting out, but he's saying blah, 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 blah. Why is he not saying words? Except for Thursday.
I don't think we're ever going to get to the bottom of this bit.
I need him to be interviewed about this interview.
You know, and now that you play the whole thing through,
yeah.
He still says to Gary at the end, good talking to you.
Yeah, he's always a nice guy. Good talking to you.
I think now that we played it again, it's Gary's fault. He's not following the script.
Hey,
do you have tape of Rockford beating up Gary Garver? I mean, like videotape?
According to no, we don't. But Gary says the guy just whipped his cane out and started beating him on the balls.
Because Rockford's got to be like 90 now.
Oh, he's a real old guy.
He's still spry. You got to give him that.
Yeah. I think Gary Garver could have kicked his ass. But, you know, you look like a real creep when you beat up an 80-year-old. That's too much.
Maybe he could have punched him once.
Dude, play that again when he says, I'm going to kick him in the balls.
Okay. All right. I'll play it again.
It's
one, yeah, you got to really listen. Crank up your radio at the end there because he really. Here we go.
Congratulations on your honor, Mr. Gardner.
Yeah, nervous. He goes, congratulations on your honor, Mr. Gardner.
You know, he's going to get beat.
Can I ask you, have you changed the world?
What?
Have you changed the world?
Who?
You. Have you changed?
Me?
Yeah.
Nothing. It changed me, but who do you work for?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Well, who they are.
You've worked with a lot of beautiful women in your lifetime. Who was the hottest woman you ever worked with?
I don't remember. I had about 28.
Okay. Is it true that you helped Martin Luther King Jr. organize his March on Washington?
I didn't help him personally, but yes, I did.
How did you do that, sir?
How did they do that?
Do you find
your phone people? What is your next list? I want to get all these down because they sound really the dumbest questions I think I've ever heard.
Do you find your penis shrinks with age?
No, but I'll tell you what, yours is.
Wow.
Because I'm going to kick you right in the balls. I knew that's who you were.
Howard Stern. Do you have a message for Howard Stern?
Back off.
For him? Talk to him in my sleep.
I back off, I said.
Thank you, Mr. Garner.
Don't you ever show up again.
Back off.
Because my cane would not be
I'm
Let him be.
That's enough. My,
your kid's going to knock me silly?
That's enough, sir.
I'm going to.
No, okay.
You see this?
Yeah.
Stupid.
All right. What?
Yeah, don't do that.
Ooh.
He said, stuff it up your beep.
He's an angry guy.
Angry geezer.
Because he was all angry even before he knew it was you.
Yeah, he's just like an angry curmudgeon.
Yeah, he's a curmudgeon, yeah.
Like, his life's been so bad.
I knew that's who you were.
It's like, like, what? The light bulb goes on.
Yeah.
Howard Stern, and you guys yelling Howard Stern.
Oh, yeah, your name murmurs all down the line. That's what's funny.
I like
Howard
he goes, well,
Stern, oh, Howard Stern, oh,
do you,
Howard Stern.
Do you think about Howard Stern, whatever he said? He goes, I talk to him in my sleep.
Oh, he wouldn't talk to you in his sleep.
Oh, is that what he said?
Yeah.
He said he did.
God, I wish he had video of that.
Yeah.
Why can't Gary take a camera with him when he does that?
It's hard, it's hard enough.
His hands are full.
He's too busy.
Oh, he did, Howard. He's got a camera.
Oh, he does?
Yes.
Oh.
Did he videotape us?
Yes, I just remembered. He's got a
camera. All right, here's my announcement.
Get that on anything.
Wait a second. All right. Here's what I'm, okay, but here's what I want to do.
No, hold on.
What?
I got to double check. He sent me some stuff with DVDs, and I'm not sure if that one's recorded, so let me double check.
All right. Because if he has a camera with him, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take that. No, that's Vinny.
Oh.
I'm going to take, hold on a second. I'm going to take that clip, and the only people who can access it are subscribers and, and, you know, only our people
right.
who are coming with us.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, subscriptions are jumping as we're talking.
No, so what you do is you have to plug in your ID number that they give you from I've already tattooed my ID number on my arm.
You have a number on your arm?
Yeah, my subscription number. That's how serious I am about all this.
Nice.
Yep.
Let me see that.
Look.
Oh, my God.
No one knows it.
You're out of your mind.
Did you reel me?
Yep. It's just a series of numbers. Everyone goes, well, what are those numbers? What are you, a fan of Lost? I go, no, dude. That's my subscription number.
And not this season.
That's right. But that's what I'm going to do with that tape. The real fans will see that.
That might be too good. You might have to give that out for free.
It is free.
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
One more thing about that Leno tape, the logic of his comedy. How come he doesn't break up when he says, isn't that mic breaking up?
Yeah, all of a sudden he's speaking.
Somebody, the mic is working. Yeah.
The mic works when he says the mic's not working. Well, he was thinking on his feet.
Play that over and over again. I love that.
You know, I've been in 1,000 meetings with Letterman, and there's no logic to that comedy.
Shut up.
All right. Thank you, Ralph. I will get that video clip to the real
fans. Oh, God.
Thank
Let's
you.
Hope he imagine exists.
Whacking the cane on him.
And his balls. Because he said to give him a good whack in the
good
balls.
Tap on the balls. Yeah.
Yeah. I'll get it up on the web.
Thank I like you. That Gardner goes right for the balls.
Oh, yeah. Very gay.
He knows how to hurt a man.
You see my cane? My cane is good. It's like a superhero. He goes, it's not me. It's my cane will beat you in the balls.
How big are your balls?
He's ball man.
Oh, but yours is, because I'm going to hit you right in the balls.
Well.
Ball man knows everyone's weakness.
All right, you want me to play it into commercial again?
Yeah.
You want
please.
James Garner?
Well, yeah. Both.
You want Leno, too?
They're both amazing.
Your balls shrink? No, but you're the Leno.
Dude, what do you think? Does your penis get...
Does your penis
get... penis shrink?
With age.
With age.
No, but yours is gonna... Yeah, what kind of great comeback.
No, yours is gonna... But with the, I mean, what kind of comeback is that? Yours is gonna...
I don't know. It's great, though.
It's like, nya.
Yeah.
Yeah, my penis is a shrink, but yours will.
And then he takes a cane and whacks him.
I got a feeling his penis must have shrunk and we hit a nerve.
Yeah, he's it's upset like, about it.
Mr. Garner, does your face hurt?
No, but yours is killing me because I'm going to hit you right in the balls.
Hang with this for a second. This is Dana Carvey being interviewed by Gary Garver.
Okay.
All right. Because it's kind of funny. After the Dana Carvey interview, Gary Garver gets into a fight with all the other journalists. They don't like him. So I think this is pretty cool.
How you doing? Hey, Dana, if you weren't an actor, what would you be?
I would be hopefully a cardiologist like PK Shaw.
Have you ever farted during an interview?
Excuse me?
Have you ever farted during an interview?
No, but I have coughed up phlegm.
Ever seen gay porn?
Have I seen gay porn? No, but you do look familiar.
Have you ever used the N-word?
Are you with Howard Stern? You're the new Stuttering John.
I don't know if you own the red carpet. I think
that's funny.
I can ask you, who is your heart? Your heart, but about love.
Who is my heart about love?
Oh.
Who is my
heart? Oh, how is your heart? How are your feelings in your heart? About
perfect.
Love?
About love? How do I feel about love? Oh, my God. This is being pretty philosophical.
She asked goofier questions than we did.
Yeah, she was planning to be nice and listen to that question.
And that's the chick who starts yelling at Gary Garver. Because she thinks he's goofy.
Love is messy, but it takes time. But it's not how you start out. It's how you finish.
How'd you like playing Dr. Evil?
Yeah, you are evil.
What? Yes, Charlie.
I am?
Yes, you are.
I love that guy's smile. I'm doing stand-up comedy. I'm taping a DVD special. And I may put this guy in it. He's funny.
Dana, if you had to have sex with one man, who would it be and why?
You.
And why?
Because you're gay.
I'm not gay.
Hey, that's okay. I don't judge.
You don't?
Oh, does this work?
How to work?
I don't know how to work. When you arrive, you
thanks, Dan.
Stern.
Hey, what do you think of Howard moving to Sirius?
I do. I like Howard a lot. I think he's brilliant.
Do you think he's going to do good in Sirius?
I think he will. I've signed up.
Really? Thanks, Dan.
Yeah. Okay, take care. Say hello to
Howard. Thanks.
Okay.
You said something clear. When you arrived here,
what?
You told me.
What?
When you arrived here, what? You told me. You told me. Can you give me room? Okay, you told me, can you give me room? I said, of course, we can share.
Yeah.
There is no problem. And
you told me,
oh, a cool guy in the media. And then you don't even let me put my mic. So, do you think you are funny? Or?
Yeah, I do.
But you are not, man.
I'm not?
No, you're pathetic.
Well, what are you going to do about it?
You are pathetic,
huh?
Man.
You're pathetic? Really?
You are pathetic, man.
Who you're working with?
Who?
Who you're working with?
K? What? I don't understand. What do you say?
Because you're a racist, I go to
I'm a racist?
Yes, I go
racist?
To sue you for racist.
You're going to sue me for racist?
Work with this person. It's so ridiculous. He's making fun of us, of the people.
I'm just trying to do interview.
Perfect. Who are you, sir?
I'm with Infinity Broadcast.
No, he's going to make fun of you.
I'm not making fun of
him. He's fun of everybody.
I'm just trying to do interview.
I believe you know.
Okay, back for now because
I met women. He pushing me and he was treating me, okay? And he's making fun of my accent like a racist.
I'm not like
you're a racist, of course. You're making fun of us.
I'm not racist.
You are.
Sir, can I ask you a step back, please?
Yeah.
Please?
I'm
do me a favor. Okay,
what?
Thank you. Right
they're,
over here.
They're the ones having the problem with me, man.
No.
Let me tell you something. If you
you know what? Don't touch me. I'll knock your ass out. Get away from me.
If you put something of this.
Wait. Get away. They already shot
me. No,
you
can't.
I'll knock your ass out. I'll knock your ass out right here.
If you put my face in
TV. Hold on.
Your owner doesn't want you on premises.
The owner?
Yeah.
The owner of Beverly Hilton?
No. We are talking about the people that are organizing this event. They
okay.
Don't want you in front.
All right. You know what? She's the one who's complaining, and not me, man. I haven't done nothing. I just was doing an interview.
Well, you know, they ask that you leave premises.
Someone flipping me off and flipping out. You know?
Yeah.
What? I didn't do anything. Dana Carvey was cool.
I am asking you now to leave the premises.
All right, I'll leave. All right, cool.
Thank you, sir.
Dana Carvey was cool.
Hey, Dana Carvey liked me.
He was cool, though.
He didn't even call him Dana, though. He called him Dana.
What are you going to do?
That's his gay name. You love that, right? You want to hear that 10 more times.
That gracious thing. I love that.
Okay, I don't remember this. This is Gary Garver with David Leisure.
You remember who he was?
The Toyota guy.
No, he was the
Joe Isuzu.
Right.
And I think he uses the F word, which I always love.
He was pissed?
Yeah.
Can I ask a couple questions?
Sure.
Who are you?
That's a good question. Next question. No, my name is David Leisure.
What made you famous?
What made me famous? I killed reporters. I was on a spree, sort of a killing spree. I was just sort of a psycho serial report killer. Yeah, I am on a spree. Yeah.
What's your strategy for happiness?
Doing to others as they would have you doing to yourself.
Do you think it was wrong of Hillary to address the Jewish people as two bastards?
Yeah, if that's what she did.
What kind of question is that?
Something happened where Hillary Clinton was accused of saying something.
Oh, but she didn't do that.
You agreed to do a movie that was also starring OJ? Probably.
No.
Not. What kind of questions are these, and who the f*** are you? Excuse me, these are weird questions. I have to say that, because I don't know who you are. What are you doing?
I'm with Infinity Broadcasting.
And what is your purpose here?
To interviews.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm done. Thanks.
Thanks, man.
That is a good moment.
What's your purpose?
Oh. I love it when celebrities curse.
Gary Garver was out at the Spike TV Game Awards. He covered it.
Uh-huh.
He got a hold of a lot of people. You know who's kind of cool? Doris Roberts, the woman who plays the mom.
On Everybody Loves Raymond.
On Everyone Loves Raymond. She was kind of cool. She was just like, what? Who are you? You know, it was just, it was weird. I'll play you that. This is a new Gary Garver. Oh, wrong thing. Hmm. All right. I don't know if this is going to happen now.
CD.
What are you doing?
It's not a CD2?
No. There's music in CD2. Hold on. The hell knows what that was. Oh, I know what that was. That was Christmas songs.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Hey.
We live in a world where millions of children are homeless and starving. Is it appropriate to honor video games?
Say it again.
I said, we live in a world where millions of children are homeless and starving. Do you think it's appropriate to honor video games?
One has nothing to do with the other, has it?
Give it. Does it?
I don't think so.
Hey, are you Jewish?
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about black people?
Their souls.
Their souls?
Yeah. Yeah.
Have you ever smoked weed?
A long time ago.
Yeah, did you like it?
You're going to get me into trouble, you know that.
Doris, have you ever had a lesbian experience?
Did I what?
You ever had a lesbian experience?
No. I like men too much.
Did you ever think about it?
No.
Never?
No. I like men too much.
Like men too much?
Yeah.
Is penis size important?
George, you want to take a
look? Yeah, please.
Jeff with Spike. How are you?
You're mad. Who are you?
I'm with Infinity Broadcasting.
Oh, okay.
Doris, so let's talk about
that. Do you ever notice that whenever he says he's with Infinity Broadcasting, people just go, oh.
Yeah, well, that makes sense.
She sounded pretty cool.
She was cool. We got a hold of Kiefer Sutherland. Of course, asked him what his favorite word is.
Oh, God, that's too funny.
But now he knows the answer it.
But once again, Gary Garver doesn't even know people's names, which is always funny.
He was calling him Keither.
Hey, Keither. Keither, let me ask a couple questions. Hey, what's your favorite Latin word?
My favorite. I've said it, gravitas.
Gravitas?
Yeah.
Hey, why is gravitas your favorite word?
What's up?
Why is gravitas your favorite word?
Well, my daughter learned Latin and in school. She's just finishing high school. And she was explaining something to me, and she did a sentence. She was kind of showing me what she had learned. And I was really proud of her, and I asked her what the sentence meant, and she described it. And gravitas was the weight of a person, but not the physical weight, the depth of them. And I just love the way she described it.
Are you glad that you never married Julia Roberts?
I'm sorry?
Are you glad you never married Julia Roberts?
Oh, it's all right. No, cheers. Thank you.
Keither Sutherland.
Keither.
Hey, Keither.
That's so funny.
Didn't we ask him what his favorite word was one time and he blew up?
Yeah,
he got mad.
Yeah, now I think he calmed down.
Well, you know, I mean, he only gave us more ammunition, so
right.
He said, I better just cool my jets here.
Where's that tape of him when we ask him what his favorite word is and he blows up? You don't have that?
Oh.
That's okay. Tom says give it away to people on the street.
How sad.
All right. Anyway, I got to take a break. When we come back, I think we should do a little tribute to Jeff the Drunk.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
All right, we'll be back.
All of his contributions.
Yeah, we'll be back right after these words.
Here's Robin calling in sick.
Hi, Gary. This is Robin. Hope you can hear this. Obviously, I am under the weather and don't think I should be at work tomorrow. So here's your heads up. Hopefully, you get this in a timely fashion. I'm going to try to get this out of me and be back by Tuesday. Bye-bye.
Hey, y'all.
Anyway, now it's time to say goodbye to all our family. Let's say goodbye to a guy who has contributed so many hours of his time, and he's just been a huge help to us over the years and certainly has become part of the family. He works out of the West Coast. It's Gary Garver. Hey, Gary.
Hey, Howard.
Hey, I wanted to give you a proper farewell. I hope you come in for the 16th and address the crowd and say hello to them.
Yeah, I'm going to make some plans to do that.
Good, because everybody seems to be coming in. In fact, we just got word that Clef Palate is coming in.
He's going to make it.
Yes.
Cool. Well, I'm definitely going to be there for that, then.
Yeah, you should be there. But anyway, first of all, I want to thank you for all the great interviews that you've done over the years, and I thought maybe we'd play a few now to remind people of how many contributions Gary Garver
made. Love his contributions to the show.
Well, thank you, and hey, you did, that was great on 60 Minutes, too. I just want to let you know that was awesome.
Thank you. Gary, well, how did you end up working for our show? I think it's been so many years now, I forget.
I've been working with your show since 1991.
And what happened was there's so many cool events going on in L.A. that when I signed up with the L.A. station, I guess Gary was working for KLSX, and he said, hey, if you need me to do some interviews, yeah, I'll go out and do them.
Well, you know, it's funny. He was a board op, I think, for our show, and,
yeah.
I called out to the West Coast, and I said, we need somebody to go out to events because we can't send Stuttering John everywhere. And it was so funny. Both the guys I spoke to go, got the perfect guy.
He's a little bit mental.
Gary.
He's a little bit, yeah, yeah.
Hey, good guy loves the show, and he'll be great going out doing these things.
What's your favorite interview you did after, let's see, 1991? Add 10 to that. That's 2001. Now, what's it? 2002, 3, 4, 5. You've been with us 14 years, and you're 14 years. Did you see the quick math?
Boy.
Yeah.
That was good.
You think?
I was really concerned when you got to 2001 and you had to count with your fingers.
Can you believe my father called me a moron? Robin, Gary's done so many interviews in the 14 years, but Gary, what's your favorite in the 14 years? And I hope I have it here if you, whatever
it
is.
I think we do.
Oh, good.
I think OJ was my favorite.
Why?
Yeah, the OJ one where it turned into a scuffle, because there's a couple of OJs, right?
Right. The first one, he was pretty cool, but the second one when we got into a fight on the golf course was a classic.
That's number three, Howard.
All right, let's take a listen to that one last time.
That is definitely my favorite.
Yeah.
Hey, OJ, can we talk to you for a second? I'll be outside out here. How's your golf game going? How's the golf game going?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Yeah.
By the way, Gary, let's just, as we listen to this, remember, Gary's got a set of balls on him bigger than any man, because OJ was with his buddies. He was not allowed on the golf course.
There wasn't, like, the public around.
No.
The police officers nearby.
Most people would have buckled right away. And don't forget, the guy also killed two people, so, I mean, you don't want to screw with him.
Yeah, and he had a golf club in his hand, too.
Yeah, this is post-trial.
Yeah, he's known to have a temper.
OJ, you know you're going through this battle with your children. I was just asking, are your kids the most important thing in your life? Don't you wish people would leave you alone for the sake of your children?
Boy, are you nervous.
Oh, hell yeah.
I mean, your voice, you can almost not get the words out.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I was surrounded by all those people, too. You know, there's like four other guys there.
Come on, OJ, can't you answer a couple questions? That's why I ask about your kids, you know, what's going on?
Guys are not supposed to be out here. I'm going to make a citizen's arrest and take this stuff.
You're going to make a citizen's arrest on me?
Yeah. So take this stuff here.
Yeah.
All right. I'm holding you. Get the marshal. We'll see. We'll see who's wrong. We'll see who's wrong.
I love OJ's always calling in the police.
He knows the law.
Yeah.
Well, he always quotes the law.
You saw him with that yellow legal pad during the trial. I mean, the guy learned something from Johnny Cox.
Does he think the police are his friends?
Yeah. I mean, he's like, well, we're going to call in the police.
The marshals.
The marshals.
Police hate me. Marshals like me.
He don't even need the police.
And you have to remember that the reason Gary can get to OJ now is because OJ has been thrown out of all the country clubs, and he has to golf on the public courses.
And, you know, I just realized OJ says marshals because I think marshals are the guys that come to collect your Heisman Trophy after it's been given away in the trial.
Yes.
You know, because he lost that civil trial, and he had to give up his possessions. I think the marshals come in and get
That's
it.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, Gary.
Yeah.
If I'm not mistaken, as I'm listening to this, there's video of this, isn't there?
Yeah, we had videotape of it.
You got to put that on demand.
Yeah, we had a cameraman, and they actually smashed the camera. You know, his guys attacked the camera and did about $15,000 worth of damage to it.
Yeah, well, I have that for in demand.
You got
to
run it.
right now?
We'll see who's wrong. That's all. Do you think there'll come a day that you'll be vindicated of the horrible crimes of which you've been accused? We will, but don't he's grabbing the mic. He's
see who's wrong.
We'll see which one of you guys are wrong.
Let us play our game.
We'll see who's wrong. I'm just asking a couple questions.
But you're illegally here, and I've told you you're illegally here, and you won't leave, so we'll wait till the marshals come and see what they do to you.
I just want to ask you.
Are you guys illegally here? Yeah.
Always quoting
them. Illegally. What do you mean? It's a public golf course. How am I illegally?
He doesn't know anything.
No.
Lawyer OJ.
He doesn't know a thing.
You're legally here.
He knows the 21 sweep from the Bills offense.
OJ for the defense.
Yeah.
A couple questions. Can I ask you after your round? Well, you hear these other grand golfers telling you to leave us alone.
Please?
Come on. OJ, just ask. Let me ask. Come on, man. What? Hey, man.
No, you guys are wrong. We'll see what's wrong when the police come.
Hey, are you keeping your knife sharp in case you get remarried? OJ? Are you keeping your knife sharp just in case you get remarried? Hey, man.
Who's laughing?
What are you doing, man? What? Have the cops come. You guys are, what are you doing, man?
You're illegal, buddy.
What?
You're illegally here.
I'm illegally here? No, I'm not. This is public property.
Well, we'll see when the marshal come. We'll see when the marshal come.
The marshal.
We will. We'll leave.
Marshal Matt Dillon.
He's making us.
What's his gun smoke?
We'll see what happens when the marshals come. We'll see what happens.
I want to know about your kids.
We'll see what happens when the marshals come.
The marshal.
But you guys, you were illegal.
Man, what's this?
Hey, Alex is fine. Hey, Alex is fine. They're wrong.
We're not wrong.
Yes, you are.
No,
you can't.
You're going to ruin that camera.
Well, we'll see. I ain't ruining the camera.
I'm not.
You guys are wrong.
Hey, look what he's doing. Hey, man. Hey. We'll leave.
Don't you realize I killed my kids? I mean, I killed my kid's mom?
Hey, man.
Don't you realize that? I killed the mother of my children.
Well, if there were no witnesses here.
Would have been great if he lost and go, I'm a mass murderer.
Are you crazy?
What are you doing? I've killed 17. Oops. I killed for less.
We'll leave. We'll leave. We'll leave.
Absolutely.
You know, all I know is the marshals showed up when OJ was busting down the door on Nicole a couple of times and they didn't do anything.
Well, he knows about calling the cops.
Right.
Because he had it done to him so many times.
The wife was always calling the cops.
You're wrong, you guys.
Hey, man. What are you doing tying this thing up? This is crazy.
We'll see who's
really?
Wrong.
You think they're gonna arrest me?
We'll see. We'll see, buddy.
You know, I've talked to you before, OJ. What?
I tell you, I told you twice.
I say the cops show up to see OJ and this white kid. I say they take OJ.
You know, it's funny. OJ, I listen to all of Gary's interviews, so there's another OJ interview, and OJ tells him the last time, too, I told you before, don't bother me on the golf course.
Anywhere else.
I don't care.
I'll talk to you off the goddamn golf course. I'm not talking to you on the golf course.
Okay, that's
you guys are totally wrong being here.
Hey, that's cool.
This is my mecca.
That's cool, man.
Hey,
how am I going to leave when he's breaking his camera up and he's tying this thing up?
You shouldn't have been out here in the first place, dude. You guys didn't pay to be out here.
I got married up here. I paid plenty of this place, okay? I got married up here. Yeah, whatever, dude. I bet you I beat your ass in golf any day of the week.
Help your ass out. Want to make a bet?
Want to make a bet?
Come on, man. Let's play golf. Let's go home.
Leave it alone.
Hey, all I ask is one question, man.
Let me ask you, what about if you're keeping your knife sharp and all that shit? That's bullshit.
Well, if you didn't attack us, if we didn't attack us,
you're attacking us up on the green.
Attacking nobody.
You're attacking us on the green.
Hey, man. Hey, dude. Hey, Matt, we'll leave.
We asked you to leave while ago.
We're going to leave.
Well, then leave then.
All right, cool.
Then leave.
Cool.
Then leave.
Cool it, man. Cool it. We're leaving. All right?
You know, I killed my wife to stop being annoyed, and you're annoying me. Who's that cat who's, like, getting all physical with you?
It was one of those guys in his group.
His posse.
Yeah.
Imagine you're in OJ's posse. Like, how do you feel about yourself? Yeah, we play golf with OJ.
Howard, you're going to see the video on this. What's going on is they're, like, on the golf course, right?
I know.
And one guy's, like, grabbing Gary's microphone and twisting it all around, and another guy's on the guy with the camera and, like, smashing it against something.
Wow.
Oh, I had to go over there and, like, break them up, man, because, I mean, they were attacking my cameraman.
You guys get on the other side of the
Hey, man.
Hey, who the f*** asked you?
Yeah.
You're sticking up for him? You're sticking up for him, man?
Come on, bitch. I had a bunch of people jumping my shit already. Bring it on.
You're sticking up for him?
Yeah.
He's got a lot of butt, you know?
Nicole.
Yeah, that is balls, man.
Yeah, he's not shaking anymore, and he's in his element now.
How about a big thank you to Gary Garver?
Yeah. Good one.
Yeah, that was crazy, man. That was crazy.
What's your favorite Gary Garver moment, Gary?
You know what? You got to go with Joe Pesci, cut four.
Oh, yeah, that was good.
You know what? It was like, it really was scary because you really think Joe Pesci is the guy in Goodfellas.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Joe Pesci's scary because he played so many scary guys.
But they're in movies.
I know, but you think maybe he's really the real guy.
But he sounds exactly the same way off the air.
Yeah, I got him at an L.A. Celebrity Police Golf Tournament. So there's a CBS. Bunch of cops.
What brings you here today?
With CBS?
Yes, sir.
Police tournament.
If you weren't in show business, what would you be doing?
If I wasn't in show business, what would I be doing?
Yes, sir.
I don't know. I don't really know.
How would you rate your looks on a scale from 1 to 10?
10.
Have you done a film where you knew the script was crap?
No.
You ever gotten aroused during a love scene?
Ever gotten what?
Aroused during a love scene.
No.
What do you think of Howard Stern?
I think he's a job.
A job?
Probably a good one, too, probably. This is for Howard. I know that, so keep going. It's okay.
You don't mind?
I said that. No, I don't mind. Ask all the questions. I watch Howard.
Who's the biggest a-hole in Hollywood?
Biggest a-hole in Hollywood. I don't know. There's too many to, like, pinpoint one. Howard better stay out or he'll probably be number one.
Are there too many Jews in Hollywood?
I don't think any more than anybody else, no.
How often do you masturbate?
Let me see. That's a lot. I don't know. It's too hard to put a ratio on, you know. Let me see.
How many dates do you have with a woman before you introduce anal sex?
How many days do I have?
Dates.
You don't speak as clear as I do, man.
No, I don't. I'm a little nervous.
Yeah, don't be nervous. I ain't going to hit you.
I ain't going to hit you over the head with a shovel.
That's what I'm afraid of.
No, they're all right. We knew this was coming. I love these questions. What was it? How many dates do I have with a girl before I introduce anal sex?
Yeah. Have you ever cheated on your wife?
No.
Have you ever had a gay...
I've never even cheated on a girlfriend.
Really?
No, I never do that. Because I feel like you put yourself down. If you pick somebody that you want to be with and then you go with someone else, it's like you're saying that they're better in a way than your choice. I mean that. I don't do that. But, I mean, I fool around a lot when I'm not with anybody, so I'm not with anybody. How's your ass?
It's nice. At least that's what my wife says.
Yeah.
Ever had a gay sex experience?
No.
Do you feel guilty about playing golf when so many people in Kosovo are suffering terribly?
Which people are suffering?
In Kosovo, they're suffering.
You mean the refugees?
Yeah, the refugees.
Oh, I feel terrible for them. I try not to watch.
Let's see. Have you ever had any run-ins with the law?
Nothing serious, I don't think, that I want to talk about.
Thanks a lot, Joe. Appreciate it.
Great, Joe Pesci. Right, there you go. We can't get guests like that, so we have to send Gary out.
You know what's interesting to me? That Gary was referring to his wife in that tape, and that's, we've gone through his divorce.
Well, Gary's crazier than OJ.
Yeah, divorced now, an ex-girlfriend just recently.
Oh,
he has no luck with
more
women.
More exes.
It happens. Howard, one of the ones you have to play, that's just a...
Leon Spinks?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my, I think that might be my favorite of Gary's, quite frankly.
Yeah, that was classic. Yeah.
Huh. How you doing, man?
I'm doing fine. I'm just doing great.
If you weren't a boxer, what would you be doing?
To lie to somebody.
Do you think there should be random drug testing for athletes?
Yeah, but most athletes smoke clean anyway. They just go to a head thing. I mean, they going to... They just make everything clean, so... Yeah, they should.
Can't believe he went into boxing.
Do you think George W. Bush should come clean about his drug use?
That's on him. That's drug use. That's on him.
Why are there so few Jewish boxers?
I don't know. They got the, I don't know what it is.
You think that blacks are better athletes than whites?
No. I think every man is equal. Every man, black or white.
Would you like to see OJ here today?
No.
do black athletes' armpits smell worse than white athletes' armpits?
I wouldn't know. I ain't got to smell it.
Have you ever been attracted to another man?
Hell no. I like fish.
Oh.
Do you know where your sphincter is?
Huh?
You know where your sphincter is?
No, I don't.
How do you handle annoying interviewers asking stupid questions?
Walk away.
And how many dates do you have with a woman before you introduce anal sex?
What?
How many dates do you have with a woman before you introduce anal sex?
The first one.
The first one? Thanks a lot, Leon.
No problem.
Thanks, Jim.
You're welcome.
That sums it up, man. What a great career you've had with this show.
No, your sphincter is... No, I don't.
So it's a sphincter, not a sphincter.
I know, the whole thing is funny.
Yeah, your sphincter is... I don't know who's more inarticulate.
You know what? I've never heard that. I heard the Pesci one. I heard the OJ one. I never heard that.
That's
I'm
great.
Hearing that first time. Like, I'm going to throw up with laughter.
I was like, Artie's going to hurt himself.
The first time he goes,
God.
He sounds like that guy that does
yeah.
It's the first.
Say, isn't him?
The very first answer is where it gets you, like,
how you doing, Joe?
Wait, that's Joe Pesci.
Leon. How you doing, man?
I'm doing fine. I'm doing great.
I'm doing fine. Yeah, same guy.
I'm recording.
How did they get Leon to do that ID?
Right, celebrity ID.
No. Well, hey, Gary, what can I say, man?
Hey, thanks a lot for everything, Howard. Really, it's been a great run.
Gary is a partier, man. I don't know if Fred remembers this. Fred, you remember in Vegas, me and you were walking to the show one morning, and we ran into Gary at the Starbucks at the Hard Rock. I have never seen...
We were going by him.
Yeah.
Him and his brother, right?
Yeah, right. I've never seen a more hungover human being in my life.
He was spinning around in one spot like a top.
So how you guys doing?
I never saw that side of Gary before.
Right, he was just out of it.
How about when he beat up his brother?
Yeah,
that's classic.
That's a good Gary moment.
Well, Gary, I hope you can make it down on the 16th to address the crowd and say hi to everyone and bye to everyone. And
I'll do my best.
And hopefully we'll work out something where you're coming with us, too.
Yeah,
so.
Gary, I got your email this morning. I'm working on it.
Okay, great. I really would love to work with you over at
I hear you.
Well, how could we do it without you?
That's right, man.
Well, thanks for everything. It's been a great run. You guys have been great, and I love you all.
Thank you, Gary.
Hey, Howard.
All right, take care.
Since all of Gary's stuff is being retired, can I just request one going out?
Go ahead.
George Takei.
You like that one?
Oh, yeah. We pull so many sound bites from that for that Fred uses as drops. Oh, yeah.
All right. Here it is as we go into commercial. The great Gary Garver with George Takei.
How you doing?
Hello again.
Which version of...
I thought you were with Paramount. That's why I obeyed you.
This is the real one, huh?
I'm just a fake impersonator.
Well, you are very credible. Which version of...
Well, tell me who you are and who you're with.
I'm with Affinity Broadcasting.
Affinity?
Yeah.
I see. I don't think I've heard of that.
Okay. Well, which version of Star Trek is the best?
Of the Star Trek movies?
Yeah.
I would definitely say Star Trek 60 Undiscovered Country, which I subtitle Captain Sulu to the Rescue.
Are you a Trekker? You're a Trekker.
Actually, I don't make those distinctions. I love Star Trek, I'm proud of Star Trek, and I revel in Star Trek. So, whatever that makes me, I'm that.
Yes. Did you ever experience William Shatner's massive ego?
We worked together for, what, how many years?
Do you think that prisoners in jail should be allowed to watch television and movies while incarcerated?
Well, I don't see any reason why they shouldn't, especially if it's Star Trek. It might make them honest.
You think all these child molesters and killers should be put to death?
Child molesters and killers should be put to death? Well, now you're at, you know, this is a personal... political issue with me. I don't believe in the capital punishment, and so certainly I don't believe in child molesters. And I mean, as heinous, as horrific, as despicable as those crimes are, you don't want to reduce yourself to the same level by killing another human being. I think we need to be above all that now. That's the Star Trek philosophy.
Do you think it's right that Ted Williams is being frozen like a TV dinner?
Like what?
Do you think it's right that Ted Williams is being frozen like a TV dinner?
You eat him?
What? You think that we could, do you wish that we could destroy the Arabs in the Middle East with a spaceship like the Enterprise?
Well, you heard what I said about capital punishment. Or was it you that asked me about capital punishment?
No, it wasn't me.
Somebody asked me about capital punishment. I thought it was you, because you've been asking all the off-the-wall questions.
Well, by the way, what do you think?
Well, I mean, you deduce. You know how I feel about capital punishment. So, extending that, how would you answer that question?
Probably no. Did you ever have homosexual feelings about anyone in the cast on Star Trek?
Do you?
Oh, did you?
No, do you?
No.
Well, why do you ask that? I mean, asking. Anyone who brings it up certainly is questionable. You got nice muscles.
That was before he came out of
right,
the closet.
Right.
He's still who would have known he was gay back
yeah,
then?
Not from that interview. You can't
do you ever pick up chicks?
Off the wall.
Do you ever pick up chicks at gigs like this?
You mean little baby chickens?
And do you think Uhura had a big ass?
She may be here. I think it'd be more prudent for me to say no comment.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Takei.
Sure thing.
Takei. Takei.
We'll be back right after this.
The next couple of days, temperature is going to stay well.
Gary Garver ran into Rush Limbaugh. I wish I could say this was better, because Gary Garver kind of didn't nail him with a bunch of questions.
Uh-huh.
But the interesting thing about it, and the only reason I'm playing it for you, is that Gary Garver's at this golf thing, and it's pretty clear that Rush Limbaugh is pretty deaf.
Oh, yeah, still?
Yeah, you know, it's not like he got all his hearing back, because... I guess because of the Oxycontin use, they say you can lose some of your hearing.
Now, didn't he have an operation? Like an implant or something?
Cochlear implant?
Yeah.
But I
thought
I don't
it
think
just
it
came back his hearing. Yeah.
No. He had an operation.
He's got some hearing back, but you can see he doesn't hear too well. But not much happens here.
Hey, Rush, how you doing?
Good.
Hey, what do you miss most about Bob Hope?
I can't hear you when you're on my that side of me. I'm sorry.
What do you miss most about Bob Hope?
Frankly, everything is the energy he brought to everything. I mean, his he was just one of the most down-to-earth, if you knew him, down-to-earth, nice guys, but at the same time, not much different when he was performing than when he was with you. I just think the whole energy of this tournament is, I mean, it's still good, but boy, when he was here, the respect that people showed by attending and so forth, I just thought he was a great man.
Is George Bush doing a good job?
Yeah, of course he is. Doing a great job against long odds.
Why do you say that?
Who are you with? I mean, I don't know.
Sirius Radio.
Sirius Radio.
Sirius Satellite.
You know, I didn't come out here to talk politics and why Bush is doing a good job and so forth.
How do you feel about Howard Stern moving the satellite radio?
I still didn't hear you.
How do you feel about Howard Stern moving the satellite radio?
Free country. Can go where he wants to go.
Yeah. Is Brokeback Mountain too gay?
I haven't seen it.
What's the square root of 81?
What's the what?
Square root of 81?
9.
And should more gay athletes come out of the closet?
I didn't hear what you said.
Should more gay athletes come out of the closet?
Gay athlete? It's up to them. They do what they want to do.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Rush.
The key question was, you got any Oxycontin?
All right.
But it was still fun.
Didn't hear you.
I didn't hear you.
What did you say?
Can't hear you on that side.
They can do what they want.
They can do what they want.
I can't stand that he's at the Bob Hope Classic. There's something that's just so repulsive to me that Rush Limbaugh's given any kind of good stuff in life.
Yeah, Bob Hope knew him.
He's such a talentless.
That's what he. That's what Rush Limbaugh.
I doubt if he ever really met
him. He hung out with him.
Larry King and Sandy Koufax. You know what I mean?
Rush Limbaugh is such a talent. I mean, okay, his talent is he does speak on the radio and he does get millions of people.
He's a good broadcaster, but he doesn't say much of anything.
See, I just don't get the Do you think George Bush is a good president? Oh yes, he's the. I mean, like you can't possibly agree with everything George Bush is doing. You can't. I mean, I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're George Bush's mother. There's got to be something you disagree with.
What do you think he meant when he said that he's doing a good job against long odds?
Well, because the whole world's against Republicans, you
but
know.
But they're in power. They're totally in power. The guy won by 3 million votes.
You know, there's a terrible terrorist threat, you know, the Democrats are painting him unfairly, wah, wah, wah. Come on. Stop it. Against all odds. Or whatever he said. But anyway, there's Rush Limbaugh on the golf course.
I'm just thinking back to when we were doing that bit with me in therapy, and you, how funny would it be if you the first problem you say to a shrink, he just goes, wah.
Oh, it's over.
Like, just sitting there with a pen and a paper, like, what a great bit. Just like, well,
Gary Garver was out in Los Angeles, of course, and he interviewed a bunch of people. I guess there was a party for the Oscars.
Yeah, they were having bunches of parties last week.
Yeah, this was a pre-party, pre-Oscar party. He ran into...
Actually, this one was the Independent Spirit Awards.
Okay, and this he ran into George Clooney. I'll play a bunch of people and what they think about it. Here's George Clooney.
Hey, George, what do you think of CBS's lawsuit against Howard Stern?
I don't understand the lawsuit yet. I didn't know what the lawsuit is. I know Les pretty well. I know Howard. I don't know what the suit's about.
Breach of contract,
meaning that he left the and
he was announcing he was going to Sirius and supposedly CBS didn't know about it.
Oh, and he was using it while he was on the show
to get listeners.
Well, I don't know. And who's doing the suing? Is it Les or is it CBS?
Sounds like Les and CBS.
Is it just an angry move, or is it, or is there some legal?
Howard used it as a bad divorce and said Les was the bitch.
But he did. Oh Jesus! Well, that always works. And well, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I bet it goes away, don't you? I would imagine that doesn't happen. It doesn't seem to make sense.
Are you circumcised?
I'm going in there right now to get circumcised.
Yeah, trust me. Okay. Thanks.
Here's Henry Rollins. I mean, just keep going down the list. People don't understand the lawsuit.
For Sirius Radio?
Okay.
What do you think of a CBS's lawsuit against Howard Stern?
I think it's bullshit. I think it's exactly what Howard says it is. It's vengeful. And the guy was going to, you know, I listen to Howard every day. And now I have Sirius, so I listen to him on Sirius. But, you know, he would talk about the upcoming satellite show because it was what he was going to do next. I don't think he was overly hyping it. And I know what they're talking about. Like, oh, he was talking about it too much. That never occurred to me as a listener, ever. I just figured he's talking about his next thing, like we all talk about our next thing. So, and it's not like anyone wouldn't know he was going to Sirius anyway. And, you know, one day you wake up and it's either Adam Carolla or David Lee Roth in a slot. You're like, oh, something's changed. Where did Howard go? You'd find out in 24 hours anyway. So I hope it gets thrown out. I think Howard is, I like Howard. I like what he stands for. So I think it's just bull.
Hey, who's the biggest a-hole in Hollywood?
Les Moonves.
I don't know many people in Hollywood.
He's the biggest asshole I've met.
I don't know how to respond to those loaded questions. I'm so not part of it that I'm not big enough to get messed with.
Are you embarrassed that our president is such a dumbass?
I'm horrified that our president is getting so many of my American brothers and sisters killed in Iraq and redefining our role and our position in the world. And I'm angry that someone like him is the figurehead of my, you know, is the go-to guy of my country. He represents the many, and it's sad.
Are you circumcised?
Yes.
And do you trust the Jews?
That's a weird question. I trust anyone who's trustworthy. I mean, that's a crazy question. I have no anti-Semitic sentiment in me.
Have you ever seen gay porn?
Yes, I have.
What do you think of it?
I just thought it was a bunch of men taking off their fake military boy school outfits and screwing each other.
Thanks a lot, Henry.
Thank you. I will wait now.
I'm awake now. Well, there you go. I mean, Henry Rollins had it right. And I've come up against so many assholes in this business, I realize this is just one more battle for me. This is one more asshole battle.
I got a little
thrown by it because it's the whole CBS thing, but I know exactly how this lawsuit came about. Les is so out of it that Joel Hollander and Steve Lehrman, the lawyer, the two of them concocted this thing. Because they're so fucking jealous of my deal over here and how good we're doing. And
it's sort of like a kitchen cabinet gone crazy?
Yeah, and Joel is doing anything he can to save his job over there because Joel can't make money with the radio division.
But how does this help? I mean, really, it's the lamest attempt.
It's throwing a big light on those three roaches over there. And the fact of the matter is that they brought this to Les, and Les went, ooh, okay, this doesn't cost me anything. I just bill it to the stockholders. Basically, you know, it's a public company. So these lawsuits, they just, you know, just cost the stockholders money.
Right, you won't get a dividend.
Yeah, well, I don't know anything about stock, but I'm going to give that stock a rating on the Howard Dow Jones. And it's don't buy. That's my rating. Beware. No, not don't buy. Beware. How's that? You got Les Moonves in charge. Beware.
It just, you know, I keep rolling it over in my head. I said, it benefits no one what they're doing. So why would you come up with this as your plan of action?
Oh, I think Les really thought he was going to win. I think he really thinks he has a lawsuit. He's that dumb. I told you, he's a bartender from the Improv. That's what you're dealing with, a guy who had a couple of good seasons picking television shows, and Sumner gave him a whole big job to do. This guy is so out of his league.
But
how many program directors?
Win, what does it do for you? It doesn't save your division.
Oh, no, they're going to keep sinking. But how many program directors? This is a diversionary tactic. How many program directors you know are capable of going into management? I'm talking
not
about
many.
You know, becoming a CEO.
They're very few.
Yeah.
That's a,
I've dealt
a
with
very
these guys.
Special program director if he can go into business.
I don't think Les knows a goddamn thing about business. I don't think he knows how to motivate a sales staff. I don't think he knows how to make money with that radio division. I think he's royally effed, and we're going to see it in the next couple of months. I think it's all going to come spilling out. And with a little help from me, I'm going to shine a big, fat fucking spotlight on that asshole.
Yeah, it wasn't a good idea to do this. It just wasn't in any way.
I'm just beginning. Trust me, I'm just beginning.
Because, like I said, you know, Les, you gotta go out.
Yeah. Yeah, Les, you gotta.
It won't be pleasant.
Basing your whole lawsuit on. Basing your whole company on a lawsuit, trying to get money from me, as opposed to turning the radio division around. Dude, you better get in the trenches and go to work.
Yeah.
Stop putting yourself at. His latest thing is he's gonna put himself in a remake of Network, starring Les Moonves.
And you know how much that's going to do for the network.
Well, we'll see.
I mean, everybody's going to tune in for a network.
That's some CEO. Man.
Hey, have you talked to Vinny since this all went down? I'm curious what his take is.
That no. Came up on the Friday show, too.
Oh, yeah?
A lot of people were saying, oh we need God. To talk to Vinny. I was like, Vinny's not calling.
Well, you get him on the phone and hear him squirm.
Well, no, I haven't talked to Vin. I don't want to put him in an awkward position.
Yeah, he can't call.
Yeah. I mean, listen, Vinny's got to work for Les Moonves, and that can't be pleasant. Trust me. You know, Vinny will tell you it is, but it's not.
Now, my other question was, now, to in order to fight the lawsuit, can you go on the David Letterman show?
All I know is, I have, since this went down, this has got to be one of the most hated guys in Hollywood. I mean, he's got more enemies out there than you could ever imagine. People just hate this guy.
What has he been up to cause that kind of...
They hate him.
Reaction.
Hate him.
Mm.
Producers, directors, talent. Everyone says it. Anyway, Gary Garver ran into a bunch of other people, too. Billy Baldwin, Richard Kind. Do you know who Richard Kind is? He's an actor.
Yeah, he's a sort of a funny-looking guy. Always plays that comic relief in sitcoms and all that.
Yeah. He even weighed in on this.
How you doing?
How are you doing?
What's your name?
Richard Kind.
What do you think about CBS's lawsuit against Howard Stern?
Well, I don't know.
bullshit. Absolute, utter bullshit. Howard is the greatest. He's the greatest. And he rails against whatever he wants to, and he gets happy against whatever he wants to. So he was talking. And now they tell him after the fact, bullshit.
Has Les Moonves ever personally wronged you?
Yes, I used to play poker with him. He's taken me for many a hand.
Really?
Yes.
And he's the biggest a-hole in Hollywood. Game one?
I luckily get the fifth. No comment.
And do you trust the Jews?
Was he waiting?
No. Are you kidding? I know me.
Thanks a lot.
You bet.
Is it for Howard?
Yes, for Howard.
Oh, that's funny.
Well, it's nice to get support from everyone.
Yeah.
Really is. I've gotten a tremendous amount of support, so it's very nice. I don't know. But I am pissed off.
Well, you know, we were having a good time. I thought about that last week. I said, we were just over here enjoying ourselves. We had forgotten about terrestrial radio and all the trials and tribulations. We were just enjoying and doing our thing. And who comes back?
Mm-hmm.
To, you know, throw a monkey wrench into the whole thing.
Well, they can't let go. They can't.
Oh, that was just some old dude.
That's the guy that runs the convention.
Exactly. Dude.
Who are you telling that to, the old guy?
No, the security guard.
He needs a shower?
Yeah, he was dandruff all over his coat and stuff. It was disgusting.
We'll talk about it. Like,
what?
I said the show's over, get out of here.
Take a shower, though.
Uh-huh. Y'all are showing him out.
Uh-huh.
Howard, can I tell you something awesome?
We can't have you harassing the mentally ill guy in the Superman outfit.
Can I tell you something I love about Gary? Over the years, I've had to speak to him probably two or three times because he's like one of those dudes that just doesn't back down from a fight.
Right.
You know, and I said to him, like, listen, you can't really mix it up with these people. But his shining moment for me was he, like, went, like, to hand-to-hand combat with OJ.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. You know, that was a great. We can't play that because we did it over at the other dump.
But did it ever dawn on you that you were fighting with a guy who probably might have killed someone?
You know, it was weird because, I'd run into him about a dozen times on the golf course before I even interviewed him. And he would come up to me and start talking to me.
Yeah, he was showing off for his friends, that's all.
Yeah, it was weird, but it was just like this weird vibe. And then when
he got sick of you.
Yeah,
sort of like
did.
What he did with Nicole.
Yeah, exactly.
Sort of like the girl
was good in the beginning, and then he got angry.
But
did you fuck Marcus Allen? Got him mad?
Well, Gary, I don't know, man. I don't know what to say. I'm sorry you're not doing well.
That's all right. Listen, I'll be better.
For Gary,
he was just skiing. How bad could he be doing?
Well, I mean, when you're unemployed, you can do things like that.
Oh, I never skied when I was unemployed.
Robin would never know she's ever been unemployed.
There you go.
What are you talking about? I have been unemployed. I didn't ski.
She doesn't have a black cloud over her head.
Neither do I. I mean, listen, you know what? Things happen in life, and you know, you got to go through the good and the bad right
now.
Can
I tell you something? You're a professional. You're funny. You got a great voice.
Thanks.
You know, you got it all going on, man. Don't worry about it.
I need a job, though, man.
Well, this is a slump, but you will rise to those heights you've seen before.
Are we paying you anything to go out and do interviews?
Yeah, you're paying me a little bit. Yeah,
but they ain't going to pay the bills.
No, I can only, I only go out maybe once a week or once every couple of weeks. So, I mean, I just need to get something going.
Maybe we can get you more interviews to do.
That'd be cool. I mean, if you guys could do that, I mean, I'd go out there and do some more interviews for you. You know
what? We'll just, like, make up shit for your interview.
Okay.
So, even if we don't want it. So you get paid.
Send us everything. Send us your conventions.
We're going to send you everywhere. We're going to send you people's homes to interview them.
That'd be great, man. Yeah. I'm ready. The homeless, whatever you want me to do. No, it'll be cool. I mean, I'll get out of it.
If things get a lot worse for you, you can look back on today and say, hey, things weren't that bad.
Exactly.
Thanks, Howard, for the interview. It is so good seeing you, and I do thank you for all the years that you've been on the show, and may you continue with our show. And let's see if we can't get Gary more work to do around here.
Well, what do you want more, work or a girlfriend?
I'd rather have the work. The chicks I don't have problems with. I mean, you know, I have problems with them once I get to know them, but I can pick them up. That's no problem. I'd rather have a job.
Are you against doing lawn work?
Whatever.
All
you
right,
know?
Okay.
Yeah, I'll do whatever, man.
Just got a patch of grass in front of his house.
remember how much worse it could be. Howard's right. Like, right now, just think how great it is not to have AIDS.
Yes, exactly. You know, no, things will get better, and I just want to say, hey, thanks for all the years, too, Howard. I mean, it's been a great run, no matter what.
We love seeing you here, and there's got to be something for you to do around here, because we got 20,000 channels going on.
Well, so. That's why I came out to New York, because I wanted to see what was going on.
Would you move here?
Sure.
Would you be willing to take a meeting with Tim Sabian?
Ah.
He'll take a meeting with anybody, won't he?
If we're going to squeeze you in between Jeff the Drunk and Bonehead Eric.
Yeah.
Kim Sabian seems interested.
Yeah, I'll take a meeting with Tim.
Kim Sabian's expressing interest.
Yes. Are you willing to shock the puss?
Would you shock the puss?
I'll shock anything. You know me.
Good for you, man.
Hey, thanks for everything.
Yeah, Tim Sabian, Jeff the Drunk. I have an idea for a show.
Yeah.
Please give me a call back, 518. Thank you.
I love it.
I love the dogs.
Shut up.
Shut up.
518. Thank you.
I'm in the middle of an important business call.
Shut those dogs up.
You guys blew it for me.
Little music from Andrew Dice Clay. This is a new single.
Three dice.
So that make you laugh enough, huh? It's never enough. You're always hungry for more. But I'm a romantic. Here, send this card to your wife. It's the crinkles in your crackle. It's your pussy juice that flows. When I come all over your monster tits, it reminds me of when it snows. Happy fucking anniversary. Romantic enough, let me tell you something. I'm the type of guy, I even take care of my secretary. Listen to this card. To my secretary with a fucking flower and a coffee cup. You're great at taking dictation. You're quite the typist, too. 100 words a minute as you siphon out my goo. You're always 10 minutes early and my coffee's always hot. But the best part about you is your hairy little fucking squat. Oh! 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 So I got in trouble for that. My wife got mad, right? So I sent to this car with like a fucking teddy bear. I'm sorry. I believe in this marriage. I believe in you and me.
Dice.
But here's a doozy. I fucked your friend Susie. It's not my fault. She looked at me. What's the problem? Hey, don't get me aggravated. Lay down, soldier.
He's on fire, huh? Lay down, soldier. That's for you, Gary.
Whackbag. Whackbag.
That's how I need it. Thank you. All right.
So I got to take a break. Thank you, Gary Garver.
Thanks, Howard.
And we got to get you something going.
That'd be awesome, man.
Talent like yours can't be ignored.
Oh, yeah, right.
I'm being serious.
Such a talent.
You want to read scripture?
Sure.
You can do the Sunday morning show.
Absolutely.
You bet. All right, we're going to take a little break. Howard 100 News telling us what's going on. John Heinen tell us what's going on. Robin will tell us what's going on. We're going to know what's going on, I think, right after this.
You remind me of Johnny Friendly. Fat Tony Galento.
Alfred Hitchcock was an asshole, but you, young man, you are not one.
Oh, yeah, I'm confusing her with the psycho, bro, too. She was.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's.
Hi, Eva. How you doing? Mr. Satellite Radio.
Look at that curly hair. That's what I wish I had. I have straight hair.
Can I ask a couple questions? Was Cary Grant full of himself?
Cary Grant wasn't full of himself. Why do you, what? That's a crazy question. He was a very talented and very sweet man who was very special, very special. He was, and that's, you know, I never heard that, and I never even thought that he was full of himself. You know? And you know what? He had a lot of reason to be full of himself, but he wasn't.
Did Hitchcock ever come on to you?
What is this for? What? No, really, what is this for?
The Howard Stern Show.
I don't like, oh, it isn't, is it?
Yeah.
No, forget it.
You don't like Howard?
No, no.
Why?
For this reason.
Thank you.
Old Hollywood rejects me, Robin.
I see you. Out of hand.
Yeah. There was something else I had to play for you, too. Oh, you want to hear Gary Garver? Gary Garver went to the O.J. trial, and... And he just stands out there. And then he got in trouble because he spoke to O.J., and I think everyone got mad. O.J. called Gary over.
Oh.
It was weird. Like, Gary, do you know the whole story? I think you know it better than I do. I don't want to get it wrong. Where's Fla Fla Flo like?
It's on Gary Garver page.
No. Gary, what happened with Gary? He was at the courthouse. Here he comes. He's got to do the shuffle into the studio. Gary Garver was at the courthouse, and O.J. called him over, right?
Right. If you play the first clip, Gary explains it.
Okay, I was just inside the O.J. trial, and actually, O.J. came up to me, recognized me, shook my hand, asked me how I was doing, asked if I still worked for the Howard Stern Show. And by the way, OJ has Sirius. He told me he had Sirius. So actually, he was pretty cool. I wished him good luck. And now we're out of here. I just got thrown out by the media cats because they got pissed off because I got in their shot. Well, everybody else is a public property. Fuck them. Anyways, for Gary Garver, Howard TV, peace. And Escape TV, I'm Gary Garver. Out.
I heard the explanation, but I still don't understand.
Yeah, what did he say?
I guess while he was talking to OJ, all the photographers were trying to get their shot. He got in the way, so they threw him out.
They can do that?
Yeah.
Why?
He said he went and applied for a media pass, and he got like the fourth pass they gave out.
Gary.
Yeah.
What right do they have to throw you out because you're in the shot?
Well, I guess it was a pull shot. It was a feed to like CNN and Fox and all that, and they told me not to get in the shot. But it was right on the street, and he was getting out of his car, so I just went for it and started asking OJ about if he was still looking for the killers and why he was such a fuck up still.
Here, I'll play that tape. This is OJ getting out of the car, but OJ doesn't answer Gary at that point.
All right.
Listen to this.
We're right here. We're right in front. OJ's coming.
We've got it on tape, but...
out of the car right now. OJ's coming out of the car right now.
I'm here.
Hey, OJ, you got anything to say today? Got anything to say to anybody today, OJ? OJ, you still looking for the killers? OJ, why do you keep on getting in trouble all the time? OJ, you got anything to say to Howard Stern? OJ, you got anything to say to Howard Stern?
Don't worry about it, man.
OJ, why are you such a fuck up?
Have faith, OJ.
OJ, how long are you going to go to jail for this time?
What?
So what does OJ do? He just keeps walking? Does he recognize
you?
Well,
what happened is he just kept on walking, and then I had a courtroom pass. So I went in the courtroom, and I was listening to the trial, watching the trial, and then one of the guys had to take a bathroom break, the witnesses, and then OJ was talking to a bunch of people there, and he saw me, and then he waved me over to talk to me and said, he asked me if I was still working for you.
And what'd you say?
I said, yeah, and I go, do you have anything to say to Howard? He goes, no, not really. And then he goes, but I do have Sirius, and I listen to the show every now and then.
Ah. Okay, let's hope OJ can continue to listen if he goes to prison.
Yeah,
I don't
want to
lose any subscribers.
He did say he's a listener. Is he paying for it or is he stealing it?
If he's stealing, we're going after him.
I didn't ask him that, but it was pretty wild that he even recognized me after 10 years, you know.
And it's still a circus, too, because OJ... Well, was it 10 years ago you confronted him on the golf course?
Yeah, it was like 1998.
Wow, that was great tape.
When
Gary Garver got a hold of OJ and he talked
on the
to
golf
him.
Course.
Oh, that's so good. I should probably whip that out. But anyway, OJ, outside the OJ trial, the new one, it's still a media circus and there's still people who hang out there and there's guys like hanging signs.
Is it like the Grateful Dead? It's time OJ's on trial again.
Yeah.
Let's go.
It's like a whole group of people. You wonder like, what have they been up to since the last OJ trial? But they're all out there. Gary interviewed one guy out there, a black guy. What, how long was he out there?
There was one guy in a rabbit outfit. I don't know which one you're going to say.
I thought they were the same guy. They sound identical.
No, the rabbit wouldn't do the interview, but his handler did the interview. You can believe he has a handler.
All right. This is just weird. Here's some people outside the OJ trial.
How you doing?
That's the rabbit.
Rabbit don't talk.
Rabbit don't talk? I don't care about that.
I speak for him.
You speak for the rabbit?
Yeah, I speak for the rabbit.
Is OJ being set up by the white man?
Yes, he is. And like the white man said of most black folks that got something or about something or want something.
If OJ goes away for life for this crime, isn't the court system really fucked up?
The court system is absolutely screwed up. If they do anything, they need to turn the man loose this morning. He ain't did nothing. All he did was go up there to get his own property. That's what he did.
If you could say one thing to OJ, what would it be?
I would say, hang on in, brother. Don't worry about it, because it ain't nothing but the truth that's going to set you free. Nothing but the truth.
What do you think killed Nicole Brown?
I think that Mark Furman killed. Yeah, he the one killed her. Yeah.
Would you ever play golf with OJ?
I'd do anything with OJ. He's my brother. Yeah, anything.
If Nicole Brown was alive, do you think she would be upset about what's happened?
Star. You know, night of 100
yeah,
stars.
Yeah, it's hard to find 100 stars.
Yeah, night of 100 stars is really the Oscars.
Here's Gary Garver interviewing. And the pickings were slim, but anyway, here's a guy who was a big star, Larry Hagman from Dallas.
Ooh.
Remember J.R. Ewing?
Sure.
All right, here you go.
It's a little bit beyond his day, isn't it?
So what? At least we got somebody famous.
Mr. Hagman, can I ask you a couple questions?
Yeah.
Do you consider yourself a good role model? I love
me and Larry Hagman? Hell yes.
Yeah? Why?
Well, I have two children. They're grown up, and I have five granddaughters, and I'm nice to them all, and they're well taken care of and educated, and sure, I'm a nice guy.
Do you support Bush's notion that gay marriage is wrong?
I don't support anything about Bush.
You don't like Bush at all?
No.
If you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
Well, at 73, I don't think they're going to draft me. I was drafted.
You never know.
At once, and instead of drafting, I joined the American Air Force for 4 years instead of two.
Have you ever had a gay experience?
A gay experience? I think when I was about 12, a guy made some moves on me, yeah.
What happened?
I avoided it and talked it over with my mother and so forth, and she kind of put me straight on what the world was like out there.
Hey, have you ever slept with a black person?
No, I never have. Have you?
Yeah, I have.
How is it?
It's all right.
Yeah, there you go.
It's all right. Cool. Hey, is Paris Hilton as idiotic as everyone thinks she is?
Who?
Paris Hilton. She is idiotic as everyone thinks she is.
I don't know her. I've never met the girl.
Hey, who in Hollywood would you most like to have sex with?
Selma Hayek.
Selma Hayek?
Yeah.
Selma. Hayek. Whatever.
She's I guess so that's beautiful. Her sister.
I like Larry Hagman. He's cool.
He's hanging in there, isn't
yeah.
he?
It's like, yeah, Thelma Hayek. But that's cool. I mean, he's got an answer. Why, yeah, everyone else is so threatened.
Right.
She's a piece of ass, isn't she?
I don't know, but she's sure beautiful.
Yeah. And what do you think of Howard Stern?
Howard Stern. I don't listen to him much. He's coming on Sirius Radio, though, and I'll probably hear more about him then.
Will you buy a Sirius Radio, satellite radio? Will you get satellite radio to listen to him?
I do. I have three of them.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, in two cars and in my home.
So you'll tune them in?
Yeah, sure. Try them out.
Great. Hey, thanks a lot, Mr. Hagman.
Sure.
Oh, look at old Larry.
I'm liking this guy. I like old Larry.
He seems like a guy who's happy to be alive, you know?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, he had a transplant, didn't he?
Right.
Yeah, like a liver transplant.
I love hearing stories when those guys survive those liver transplants.
Yeah. I like Papa John Phillips got a liver transplant. They went out drinking. And they followed him with TV cameras.
I love that. You know, I had to test it. It was the liver of a woman who had never drank.
It was like, caught on tape. Papa John Phillips. They got him in a bar having like Mai Tais. And
in the middle of the afternoon.
And they pulled him out, and then they would follow him with the camera. But
he was drinking Long Island iced teas. And I remember that because it's pure alcohol.
He's got a new liver.
But he had a brand new liver, and it turned out it was from a black woman who was a church-going church woman.
In Atlanta or something.
Yeah,
I remember
teetotaler.
That.
She never, the liver never had any alcohol.
Well.
And apparently didn't like it too much. Yeah. Papa John's not with us anymore.
No, but he had a couple of good years of drinking.
Is that what happened? Did that liver give out?
I don't know. I just know he's gone.
He's gone. He died.
I think he had a heart attack.
Yeah. He was a good soul, though. You know, maybe a little confused, but a good soul.
Well, somewhere in there was a good soul.
All right. Then he ran into Gary Busey, who's always an interesting interview. I haven't heard any.
He was at 100 stars?
Yeah. I haven't heard any of these, by the way.
Gary.
Hey.
Okay. Gary. How you doing?
Good. Very good.
Do you consider yourself a good role model?
Who with?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Who?
Infinity Broadcasting.
Okay.
Do you consider yourself a good role model?
I'm not really the one to judge that. I know in the way I'm living now and what I've discovered through the journey of my life, yes, I am going to be, and I am, a good role model.
Were you before, or did this come about?
I love this guy.
Oh, yeah.
He's the best interview ever. He always sounds like he's wasted.
I think there's a reason for that.
It just sounds, hey, I'm hearing those voices again in my head.
Me too.
Now, do you two suffer the same psychosis?
No. We work for the same radio station.
These voices are saying, kill a dog.
Every time we hear that, what is it?
I don't know. It's pretty prominent right now.
No, hold on. Now, you just...
What happened? He did something.
No, I hear it.
There again.
What is that, Fred?
You know, it can't be. I thought it might have been the headphones because, like, the guy runs the commercials in the other room, but it's not that. So it's.
I thought we isolated the problem already.
It's always something new.
Oh, I got it. Listen to this.
What is it?
I don't know. Somebody shut it off. I don't know how.
What happened?
Hey, whoever's doing that, can you stop it? You must know what you're doing.
I was always growing into that mold.
Hey, if you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
What?
If you're drafted to go to the war in Iraq, would you go?
Well, that's a stupid question because there is no draft.
Do you remember what song was playing when you lost your virginity?
Do I remember what kind of pain I caused when I lost my virginity?
The song was playing.
What?
You support gay marriage?
What's this about, man? What are you doing here?
What? I'm asking questions.
This is an Oscar show. This is not political canvassing.
I'm just asking. What, do you support gay marriage?
It doesn't matter. No, it doesn't matter if I support it or not.
Have you ever slept with a black person?
Goodbye. Good luck on your internet.
Hey, let me ask you one more.
Hi. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to interrupt you guys. Okay.
No, these questions are wrong. What? Hey, what do you think of Howard Stern?
Those four questions have no respect in them.
They don't have any respect? They're just questions.
Sure.
They're stupid questions.
What do you think about Howard Stern, what the government's doing to him?
Go ahead.
You look very handsome tonight. May I just say?
Give me a hug.
Give me a hug?
Did he just ask that woman for a hug?
Yeah.
That's got no respect. Give me a hug, honey.
What's James Cromwell? I don't even know who that is.
He's an actor, and he's on 6 Feet Under, and he's in the pig movies, Babe.
Great. Mr. Cromwell, how you doing?
Fine, thank you, man. Good, thanks.
What's the most exciting thing about Oscar night?
Getting free food, seeing your friends, and going home. Watching the show, enjoying the laughs, and not having to worry about sweating it out about whether you're going to make one or not.
Does it bother you that these big Hollywood events are taking place while our soldiers are being killed in a senseless war?
It certainly does. I know that's a very sensitive question. In actual fact, this whole celebration is obscene, given the circumstances. And I can understand how the rest of the people in the world going through this, especially people in the Middle East, would say, what is the matter with those people? It's unfortunate that this has been made into such a zoo. It's basically a community of actors and a community of directors and people in this industry acknowledging people's excellence to have it blown into celebrity and ratings and money is slightly obscene.
Wow, that guy's cool.
Why is he there? He's a major activist. Very political.
I dig him.
But he's out there.
Yeah. And
he's
worked,
participating in
it. I worked with him.
Someone told me he's the guy in the Star Trek movie who discovered warp speed.
Yes, that's right. He did that too.
He's also Stretch Cunningham from All in the Family. He is.
That's right.
Is he really?
Yeah.
I worked with this guy on a movie. I worked with him for about a month. And he's like a real political guy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And interesting.
Here's some things I found out about him, Howard. He was once arrested in Virginia. Him and a bunch of people from PETA went to Wendy's, and they just wouldn't leave, so they got arrested. And he's been in a bunch of Star Trek movies.
That ain't cool, though. You can't go to Wendy's and bum people out about their food. Somebody wants to eat steak, let them.
Well, he feels that's wrong.
And
big-time vegan.
Yeah.
But he's the kind of vegan where you look at him, he looks like he could use a roast beef sandwich. He looks like he's getting a little...
It says here he's a believer in non-terrestrial intelligence.
Yes.
Non-terrestrial intelligence. What's that?
I don't know.
That would be alien intelligence.
No.
What?
No. Non-terrestrial intelligence.
Right.
That means not of this earth.
Extraterrestrial is not of this earth.
Well, non-terrestrial would also be not of this earth.
I have something to say about that.
Non-earth. He's into non-earth.
Non-earth intelligence.
And maybe he really is the guy who developed warp speed.
And he was in Star Trek. He did a bunch of Star Trek stuff.
That's what I just said.
Yeah.
He's the guy who developed warp speed.
Yeah, he was in one of the best Star Trek movies ever.
Okay. What is the name of the guy, the doctor, who developed warp speed?
Well, I have it here.
Oh, don't you say it, then.
Oh, God.
If you remember this, this is good. Then you're
I'm
real.
Not that big a geek.
If you know this, you're a turd.
Yeah, I could think about this for 42 years. I wouldn't have a guess.
Ralph should be calling up right now.
Fred, do you know?
I knew he was in that movie, but I don't
know. I think it's Thaddeus.
I know they used to refer to him all the time.
Wait, am I right about the first name, Thaddeus?
They're saying that this is a Star Trek character. They give a name. Is that
Phineas?
That? No.
What?
Zephram Cochran.
Yeah, Zephram Cochran.
Zephram Cochran, that's right.
The warp speed.
He's the only character to be mentioned in all five Star Trek series, and he was the only guy that actually used the word Star Trek in a Star Trek movie.
Why?
It just said that you're all astronauts of some kind of Star Trek. I don't know. They have all these Star Trek facts here about him. He's also the tallest Oscar-nominated actor ever.
How tall is he?
6'7".
Do you support gay marriage?
I certainly do. I think gay people should have all the rights of any other citizen. They're citizens. They shouldn't be deprived. Whatever they want to call it, that's fine with me.
Michael Jackson, guilty or innocent?
Oh, I have no idea, mate. That's why we have courts of law.
Hey, do you remember what song was playing when you lost your virginity?
I wasn't listening to the radio. No.
Have you ever slept with a black person?
Yes.
Right, thanks a lot.
He answered all the questions.
You know, if I remember correctly, he told me that he used to work with the Black Panther Party.
Oh, yeah?
In the early 70s.
Oh, so I wouldn't doubt it. He is radical.
Yeah. So he probably got a lot of black poontang.
Yeah, that's cool.
Radical.
He's also great in the movie L.A. Confidential. I
Yeah, he's the bad guy.
Come on, baby.
No, all right.
He's done a lot of stuff.
Zephram Cochran. I got some other people here, too. George Lopez. I don't know him.
He's on that. He has his own TV show.
Howard, that's just 50 seconds of George Lopez kissing your ass.
Yeah.
Oh, let's hear that.
Yeah, maybe I'm a new fan.
What do you think of Howard Stern?
I think he's great. Yeah. Wait, all the time.
What do you think about what the FCC?
You know what? I think when he gets to serious radio is when radio will really take off. I mean, and I think it's like a rocket that's going to blast off and leave part of its tail behind. I mean, FM has never been a place for creative people. And to me, Howard Stern is like no other guy who's ever been on the...
Wow, look at this guy.
Who knew?
What show is he on?
He's on the George Lopez
show.
I'm going to start watching this thing. I'm watching this guy.
Radio, and there's a lot of morning guys and Billy and Bob's and all kinds of guys like that, but no one even comes close. Mancow or whoever's out there, no one comes close to what the guy does day in and day out. And, you know, I'm not a serious radio holder right now, but when he goes, I will become.
Well, thanks a lot, George.
All right, dude.
He's one of that one in five.
He must have missed that survey. Hey, I like this guy, George Lopez. That's my guy.
He's a good guy.
Is he a stand-up?
He's a stand-up comedian.
He was
comedian.
A stand-up, and now he has a huge TV show's a hit.
The very business tough. He does at clubs is unmatched.
He's
like, sells
funny
out.
And very filthy.
Yeah.
Is he filthy? I like
it's
that.
Great, though.
He loves you. I met him at Hollywood Squares once. I mean, he loves you.
Yeah.
Didn't
and,
know that.
And he got his show because Sandra Bullock saw him. She's
right.
The one who got him on TV.
Oh, wow. Well, that's a cool dude. Says some nice things. You know, you don't hear too many people saying that kind of stuff. All you hear is like, you know, I'm a scumbag.
Well, not successful people anyway. Usually it's Larry Flint.
Yeah. Yeah, usually Larry Flint's defending me, which is fine, but...
Yeah, but you need help from other quarters.
And George Lopez, thanks, man. Give you a shout-out, didn't I? I hope you get your American citizenship, man.
The show's on ABC for the rest.
All right, I'm going to watch it. I mean.